Hello, everyone, and welcome to the first of our Halloween commentaries. We're back to the Harry Potter franchise with Goblet of Fire.
At long
Yay.
last.
AKA, let's AKA the bullet train of the Harry Potter film, just in terms of pacing.
All
And
right,
the teenage angst movie.
Who's the director
Sure,
this
sure,
time?
sure, 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 sorry, the teenage angst movie, that's Harry Potter 5, I
Mike
think you're thinking
Newell.
of.
It's directed by Mike Newell, who would later go on to learn absolutely no lessons from this and make a crappy Prince of Persia movie.
Apparently,
Yikes.
part of the reason for the change in directors was a mixture of things. One, the director from the previous Harry Potter film, I believe he was busy with schedule stuff. And two, well, some audiences did not take all that well to a lot of the changes in direction, which was incredibly apparent, as you may recall
Funny
from
you
our
mentioned that,
commentary.
Jova, because we're about to see one in the, at the very, right at the beginning. So take us
Oh,
away,
joy.
Shiro. We need to start, in case you're wondering, audience, we need to start with the black screen right before the Warner Bros. Logo.
Yep, as if you're
All right.
pressing play on your Blu-ray.
Go ahead, Shiro.
Everyone ready?
Ready. Yep.
Yes.
All right. 3, 2, 1, click.
So, Tio, what is it
I
we're
don't know.
about
I
to see
can't.
one of?
Basically, at the beginning of, keep in mind, by the time you saw this movie in theaters, I already had read at this point the book, and the book pretty much starts with Harry, the usual way the Harry Potter book story start, Harry in the Dursleys' house, and the Weasleys go get him to, in this case, go to a Quidditch tournament. Here, well, aside from this beginning, we're gonna skip that part, like.
Oh,
And I
yeah, a bit of a
remember
shame
that piece in
personally.
interviews. I get that it's pointless, so you don't really need it, but at the same time, why
Well,
cutting
Teo,
it away?
that's the thing. This movie's already 2 hours and 40 minutes. I mean, you have to trim it down because of the sake
True.
of
Honestly,
it. Well,
okay. There's a right way and a wrong way to trim stuff down.
spooky.
Yeah. It's like,
Well,
okay.
considering the climax of this movie, it makes sense to start on that, if you ask me, to set up the
Not
tone.
quite, because it's probably not a good time to mention this is a movie that kind of suffers from cutting a bit too much out, but we'll get to that later. But on the topic of how
Was it
much
Order of
you
the
adapt.
Phoenix that one had a problem with that?
No. That's this.
That, I think that's still at something, but again,
But,
Order of the
hang
Phoenix
on.
was one of the cases where it
So
was
where do we
good.
start, Dweebs?
Oh.
Sorry?
Where are we now?
Allow me.
We're
Someone
near.
shoot the house, apparently.
Yeah. I forgot. Sorry, I've forgotten that. I think it was Grimald Place. I think the name of the house is I've forgotten.
No. Grimald Place is, well, that's not a place brought up yet.
Godric's Hall is where his parents are buried. I'm actually
Basically,
not sure what the name of this house is.
these four muggle is tasked to check that house where you see in the background, and apparently someone is pulling again a prank.
Basically.
If there is one positive thing I can say about this movie is that, in my opinion, it's got the best Harry Potter score not done by John Williams.
Who's the scorer for the composer?
Patrick Doyle.
Okay.
Maybe it's just because I haven't read the books, but personally, I find this movie to be pretty much as good as the other ones for me, honestly.
Well, that's the same. In the case of a missing content for me is just more noticing
Yeah,
than
yeah.
being pissed off.
In terms of people who have complaints about.
Little Hangleton, that was the name of the place.
Right. Basically, backstory here. A family used to live here until something really bad happened, and apparently most of them died.
Also, this beginning kind of remind me a bit of Darby O'Gill and the Little People. I don't know why.
Now, okay.
Anyway.
Now, in the book, they kind of mention who the family name is, but since they don't mention it already in the movie, I'll leave that as a surprise for you people who
To
haven't
be fair,
read the
it's
book
pretty
or seen the
much a
movie.
given. Hello, Peter. Oh, and hi,
I'm
the
the
doctor.
doctor.
David Tennant is in
Did we
this
put on the wrong movie?
movie.
Yeah,
Yeah.
apparently we're doing the another one of them crappy Doctor Who Dalek film adaptations.
Yeah.
A danger noodle.
And there is the all powerful Nagini, who apparently now was once a South Korean model. Thanks, Rowling.
Oh boy.
Oops.
That smile.
Meal time for Nagini.
Flush me.
Tea's ready.
Harry, keep your hands up, please.
All right, let's get into step.
Hermione, how long have you been here?
Just now. Jenny just got there.
By the way, speaking of Emma Watson, fun fact: there's a meme on the internet that Emma Watson and Richard Dawkins have the same face.
Really?
No, seriously. Check. Go to Google. Check Emma Watson, Richard Dawkins, and you'll see it. Like they they have the same facial structure and features. It's quite uncanny.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, so yeah. Yep. Basically, Goblet of Fire, from what I can recall and from what even IGN seemed to have reported, Goblet of Fire seems to be... Oh, hi, Cedric.
It's Edward.
Can I introduce this actor, please?
Which one?
Sure. The one playing Cedric.
Go on.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Cedric is played by Robert Pattinson, who was the male protagonist in one of my favorite comedy series, Twilight.
You know, it really goes to show, most people in this series got typecast for being in their Harry Potter roles. Robert Pattinson was one of the only few to not get, you know, typecast for that. Only shame thing is, he got typecast for Twilight instead.
I actually like him in this movie, quite honest.
Oh, yeah, I like him too.
Well, that's the thing, he has the very, very clearly big misfortune of being an awful tough.
And I will say this, though, at the very least, he's a lot, he's a bit better than he was in the book, but, you know, he wasn't terrible in the book, per se.
I take offense to that, Tio. We're great.
I know.
Wait, oh! Let's see. Well, when I took the test, I got Gryffindor, so I was glad about that. Let me guess, you
already... And their spines turned to dust.
Show-offs.
Yeah, okay. Oh. I'm checking my arms. I've only got a light sprain on my elbow. That's good.
Joy.
There you go, a Quidditch tournament.
Oh boy,
looks
guys,
more like
I can't...
Greece than me.
Guys, I can't wait to see the Quidditch match, can you?
That's actually...
We'll get
was a
to
Mexican
that when
flag.
We get to that. But yes, as Theo mentioned...
Well, actually, that was an Hungarian flag, sorry, my bad.
As Theo mentioned, a lot of stuff did get cut from this movie, and admittedly, while it doesn't hurt the movie...
Well,
aside
from the beginning,
Joe,
I don't remember any particular stuff that was cut.
You'll see. But anyway, though,
There you go.
But yeah, going back to that, yeah, like you mentioned, one of the fierce scenes that's cut is a funny scene with the Dursleys. Admittedly, though, it's not the most important thing, so I could see why they skipped that. However...
Basically, the Weasleys get in the house and they burn the Weasleys' chimney down.
By accident. And then...
Yeah.
And then the Dursleys just try to kill him. But yeah... Of course, always larger on the inside.
It's bigger on the inside. These people have TARDISes.
Oh wait, here comes the quote. It's been 4 years since
four
you
years
dealt
and
with
you
it.
Say that.
Well, Teo, at least I didn't say that he hated magic.
So basically, we're here to see the Quidditch World Cup finale against Hungary and... was the other one Scotland?
Bulgaria.
See the Wakandan embassy also participated. Oh, hi, Lucius.
Hey, I'm still not evil, by the way.
We kind of already established he was evil in book two.
Oh, yeah, is it
just...
Well,
that's my whole joke. This guy lacks any sort of subtlety.
Yeah, Joe, it's funny watching this film, considering this came out the same year that Avatar The Last Airbender started.
Hold on. Enjoy yourself while you can. By the way, did I mention that I'm not evil?
Oh,
he has a snake with an open mouth.
I'm
baton.
Just your common asshole. I'm not evil.
Is there a character Jason Isaacs has played that's not evil?
I
need to remind you again, he played Satan in a video game.
Oh,
I get how lower can you go from
remind
there?
Remind me again.
And he plays Dracula in another movie.
Remind me again, what's his job?
Oh, so I was right, it is the Irish. Well,
you mean
no.
Lucius, the character
yes.
Lucius' job? I think it works at the ministry.
So I'm guessing he was hired by the Sultan of Agrabah. I mean, because, I mean, let's think about it. I mean, the Sultan of Agrabah hired a clearly evil, slimy-looking guy with a snake scepter. Yeah, clearly this guy's legit.
So, yeah, this will be a Quidditch match between the Irish and, of course, the Bulgarians.
It's totally going to be exciting, right?
It's the Quidditch World Cup.
Yeah! And, of course, here's Crumb, the seeker for the Bulgarians.
By the way, buy the video game.
Which one? The Quidditch World Cup game or the Goblet of Fire game?
Quidditch World Cup game.
Yeah.
By the way, Shiro, I noticed there on that image, you can see there, Emma Watson and Richard Dawkins have the exact same.
No, morph. I looked it up. It's uncanny.
Oh my god. Richard Dawkins, you say?
Richard Dawkins. He's a university professor. Basically, they have the exact same facial features. It's so weird.
Anyway,
pictures in the chat. Like,
anyway, the reason I'm bringing this up is sorry. Go ahead.
All right. It's starting the match, and
we cut.
Okay. This.
If you weren't going to show the match, why did you show the build up in the first place?
Yeah, this is one of the first of many cuts. That a lot of fans.
No.
Nope. Oh, yeah, that's actually a funny thing about that.
There is a deleted scene, but from what we have seen, it's only way later. It's for a very pointless thing.
Here is the thing when it comes to certain Harry Potter movies. Originally, Warner Brothers had made a deal that each movie would get its extended edition so that fans could get a chance to see movies at their full glory. Here's the problem. Harry Potter 3 and 4 ran into difficulties, to sum it up, without going way too long. So we never got the full fleshed out editions. And let's just say, while it didn't hurt Harry Potter 3 as much, Harry Potter 4 cuts out a bit too much. Yes, I know it's long already, but let's just say there are a lot of details that fans of the book or fans who didn't read the book kind of were missing out of. Oh, and fans who didn't read the book were really...
Unlike all Ku Klux Klan match.
Yep.
Also... unlike The Lord of the Rings, which was a big project but just contained in 3-4 years, Harry Potter spanned through basically almost a decade.
Yep, it was
just
pretty...
on its own. So I can imagine the strain by the fourth movie.
I will say this, though. It is clear that they let the strain with the fourth movie get to them a bit too far. Like, okay, this is a little too early for the pacing of this movie, especially since, I know some may not believe me, the Quidditch game actually does kind of matter in the grand scheme of things for the story of Goblet of Fire, but kind of gets glanced over. I'll explain more on why that is when it becomes relevant. But yeah, there we go. Like, we're only 11 minutes in, and already we're getting to this scene of, well, the field's getting burned down and Harry getting knocked out.
With a terrorist attack.
Yeah, essentially.
Yeah, and who was the leader of said terrorist attack?
The doctor.
The doctor.
My favorite doctor.
I mean, you can tell me whatever you want.
Is that what we're just going to call him throughout this entire movie?
You can tell me whatever you want, but it's totally headcanon considering the laws of Doctor Who.
I mean, look. He literally stole...
that face.
I mean, look, he's literally stolen the Ninth Doctor's jacket.
Question. Was David Tennant playing the Doctor around the time of this movie?
No.
Yes.
Yes? Let me check the date.
He regenerated into David Tennant at this point.
Well, huh. You know, Dweebs, it's... Yeah, all right, 2005. Yeah, that's right.
Wow, perfect timing, man.
Ecclestone lasted only one season.
I'll admit, I had no idea who David Tennant was, but God, have I grown to really appreciate
it's
him.
It's that kind of trope drove a bit hilarious in hindsight, but also, you know, the type of cast. Jesus.
Wow, shooting on sight! Quite relevant.
Well, at least they go stupefy and not... You're not about a cadaver...
Hey, Barney Crouch.
This guy looks like a more subdued J.K. Simmons.
Who the heck who plays him?
Barty Crouch Sr., let me check. 4.
He also looks like an amalgamation of the two DuPonts.
Oh my god, he does.
Yeah, anyway, the actor who's played the old guy who just said, "Yo, what you called you the dark mark?"
That's Thompson's, for those who are English speakers.
He was Fun fact, he was in a popular
Roger Lloyd Pack.
Yeah, he was in a popular British sitcom called Only Fools and Horses.
Roger Lloyd Pack, huh? Name doesn't.
And he was also John Lumick in the first revived story featuring the Cybermen.
Oh, it was in 1984 as well.
And we're already off to Hogwarts. Now, okay, it's nice that we're getting to Hogwarts and stuff, but again, this sort of brings up a pacing issue, I said. And don't get me wrong, folks, I actually do like this movie better than Harry Potter 3 for my own reasons, but that does seem to be the big split. It's either fans liked how Harry Potter 3 was constructed, or... Anyway, going back to something that doesn't make me
rage. I told you this was the start of the teenage angst movies.
But sure. Order of the Phoenix is where it comes to the real big point.
I guess.
I thought that was Half-Blood Prince.
But this movie sets the foundations for it.
Also, I keep forgetting, what's the name of Hermione's cat?
Crookshanks,
yeah.
Also, Dwibs, we don't talk about Harry Potter 6.
We're going to have to soon, unfortunately.
Yeah, and
they have problems, but I still enjoyed it, honestly.
Harry Potter 6 was just joyless, but more on that later.
Yeah, we'll get to 6
eventually. Not on Harry Potter 6 yet.
Now, here's a weird thing I always sound. Yeah, despite the fact that Sirius Black, as far as most of the Wizarding World knows, is still out on the run, Hogwarts seems more lax. I guess Dumbledore was really able to pull those strings.
Jover, if it isn't already obvious at this point, Hogwarts is such shitty security.
No. Yeah. Well, that's the one thing, though. It was the Ministry who ordered the usage of Dementors, though. Wonder what got them to give up the usage of them, despite the fact that they attacked students.
Yeah, maybe that was why. They couldn't... There was no way they could... There's no way they could duck that controversy 2 years in a row.
Well, you know what, guys? I'm pretty sure this year will finally be a year safe for students at Hogwarts, the safest place in the gosh dang world.
Totally.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Alverni's better.
Here come the transfer students from Hagrid.
Yep, from France.
Hagrid, maybe.
And Bulgaria.
I'm down, Joker.
That would have been quite a way to kill off Hagrid.
Oh, and look at that! Another transfer school from Bulgaria.
More like the Caribbean, because
oh god, the Flying Dutchman,
the freaky black pearl.
That is a cool ship. I'll give him that.
True.
When they say Hogwarts is the safest place, what they actually mean is it's the safest place from anything that happens outside it.
Maybe. I wonder if they're literally saying Hogwarts is the safest place just because they know it'll get people to try and...
Yeah, this is where Filch starts to become comic relief.
Wasn't he bitten by the dog or something while trying to feed him?
Well, unfortunately, we get skipped over on that, so it just leaves people confused who haven't read the book.
Also, Another thing that seems to be a point of major contention is Dumbledore.
Oh!
We'll get to it in a second. Basically, the point of the story is that this year, Hogwarts has been chosen to host a particular tournament involving a dangerous task only for the students of, forgot which specific year upward.
Safest place, fucking hell.
So basically, this is a Triwizard tournament where... Just free, even though there are plenty of wizarding schools all around the world, will, you know, have these challenges.
First of all, the Bobaton class from...
Bobatons.
Some of which are descended from nymphs, said in the book, which is why they have a certain ability to attract.
I'm not sure if this is being stereotypical of the French.
I don't see any baguettes, Dweebs, so I think we're fine.
Again, Dweebs, in the book...
And the professor is a giant. Giantess.
Oh, yeah. Subplot on that sadly gets axed in the movie. But more on that later. But yeah, it's kind of hinted at that one of the students may be descended partially from Nymph, which is why she has a certain sway to her.
Isn't it well, how it's incorporated in the second trial?
No, I don't think so. So.
Dumbledore likes big women, apparently.
From the north. Well, Carlisle.
How convenient. A school with only girls and a school with only boys. Well, Hogwarts is the one in the middle. Oh, by the way, Flitwick seems to have de-aged somehow.
Well, he looked like that in the third film as well.
Did he?
Yeah. It's a change that started happening after the Chris Columbus era.
Well, either way, though, yeah, that was something I never got. Oh, and look at that, it's Crumb. Okay, this is where I bring up one of the reasons why cutting the Quidditch match was kind of stupid. Let's just say part of Crumb's character is kind of hinted at, but also built up to properly using that Quidditch match. Essentially, his team does get the snitch, but the Irish win the game.
But it seems someone is late for the party.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, yes. But more on him later.
Also, it's a good thing they cut out the Hogwarts song, because compared to the other two introductions, it's
there was supposed to be a scene where the Hogwarts students performed a song in response to this, but I haven't seen it, but I've been told it's very goofy.
Yeah, and the guest students don't look very impressed by it at all.
Hagrid, what the fuck, man?
Dumbledore, you asshole, you told me to take a right at Glasgow.
And that's what's being used to choose the participant in the Triwizard Tournament.
Oh, here we go.
A few words.
Eternal glory.
And loss of limbs.
Yes.
Troy, I'm sure nobody died the last time we held a Triwizard Tournament.
Well, in the book, they say there was a death toll.
And hey, there's good news. Someday that old contestant will wake up from that coma.
How long was that ago, though, Jova?
10 years.
Oh.
Also, Barty Crouch looks a bit
Peter Sellers.
I was about to say, he looks a bit like a combination between Peter Sellers and Adolf Hitler with the hairdo and stash.
And here's our new professor for the Dark Arts, for Defense Against Dark Arts.
Ah, yes.
Mad-Eye Moody.
He's played by Brandon Gleeson in this film. But,
He's a bit drunk.
Jesus, fact.
Again, another example of shitty Hogwarts security. The roof can that magical roof can be so easily broken down.
It's a bit of a fritz.
And apparently he has a drinking problem. Fantastic.
Well, he walks like it.
I'm sure it's not important.
Yeah, I'm sure it's just a medical drink.
Or like we said, he's an alcoholic.
Yeah, there you go. Under the age of 17 plus.
Now this is a weird change, because like in the book, it was already pretty much a stated law that, you know, if you were under 17, you pretty much weren't allowed to. But apparently, this is something that the Ministry just out of nowhere decided, oh, maybe we should talk about this now.
Actually, Jover, I think that was in the book too.
I don't remember that.
No. If I recall correctly, that was already the set rules.
Hold on, wait for it.
Oh, boy.
Roll credits.
Unless you're under 17, you plebs.
Oh,
we're
totally
not panning to these specific people for a coincidence.
No Sounds pressure.
Exciting.
If we're all participants. Hang on, if it's already begun, then that means we're all participants. So shouldn't it be called the 100th Wizard Tournament?
Again, Dwibs. Again, Dwibs. For some reason, only free wizarding schools.
And yeah, don't worry, they'll explain that. They'll explain that magical line.
Oh, yeah, right.
The professor of Durmstrang, who, let's just say, has a bit of a dodgy past history.
He's played by Predrag Bjelak. What he did. Oh, he was in the Prince Caspian movie. Fantastic.
Oh, goody.
Oh boy, practical defense against the Dark Arts. 10. Fuck, bastard, bollocks. Oh.
All right, let's talk about the three unforgivable curses. I have to wonder, how does somebody create these spells in the first place?
The lore is not that rich.
Yeah, I'm not gonna bother going down that road.
He's also not dead.
Thank you. Four wrong.
Fuck you. You asked for a curse, sir. Not an unforgivable one.
Imperius, sir.
Oh, don't worry. It'll give him a lot more grief about 3 years from now.
Yep. You.
Don't worry, they're harmless.
So let's test with a spider.
Aw.
Let's make it a little bigger, though.
Yeah.
So this first curse is actually very simple. Control over a body.
You can tell why that would definitely be considered immoral.
But at the moment, it's hilarious.
Well, again, I Hold honestly kind of like this approach.
Oh,
it's
poor Ron.
Showing.
Yeah.
Wait. Oh, you deserve it.
Nah, I don't feel bad for Draco.
However.
That's another thing. I kind of wish...
Not so funny when you get down to that.
Anyway, go on, Vader.
That's another thing. I kind of wish... I know that the whole thing of Draco is that he's the bully type of character that later gets redeemed and stuff like that. But I think I don't know if the books did it differently, but the movies don't really give him enough focus so that he becomes an interesting character enough for us to care about him in the final book. Honestly,
oh,
I never care much.
Yeah. Good point. In fact, that's another point.
Did the books do more with Draco?
Yes. Although, I will say this, though, in terms of book 7...
Oh, this particular one. Neville knows particularly this next curse.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Very nasty.
Yeah.
A curse made essentially to torture. You don't know what it does to the person, but just imagine the worst possible thing and multiply it by 10.
It's clearly painful.
Yeah, yep. It's not nice. And Neville's not exactly having a...
Having too much fun there, Moody?
That poor spider.
You know, what if, like, the ministry detected that he was doing this on the way he was giving a lesson and just burst in and arrested him?
They don't pay attention to anything. We've established this.
And the third one, the most despicable of the curses. So much that the muggles apparently twisted the words into a fun children word. The Avada Kedavra.
The killing curse.
I actually appreciate this nice touch, the fact that it's basically a distorted, darker, and edgier version of the classic magical words that everyone knows.
And the one person who survived a killing curse? The boy with the glasses.
Of course.
And the scar.
Should you really be drinking in front of your students?
Nope. I guess it's
I
in the pension
it's,
plan.
It's for medical reasons.
Shiroi, considering the dangers that wizards have to deal with out there, the whole drinking teacher thing seems very tame and insignificant. I mean, how do we even know that's alcohol? Is it? Is that ever confirmed that it's alcohol?
Oh,
at the end, yes. It's confirmed what it is.
Okay. Then.
Let's just say this. You'll see. Oh, boy.
Well, I have seen this. It's just that it's been a while.
No, I know what he has, so.
However, here's an interesting thing. Madame Moody actually does come to try and comfort him after it. This is an interesting thing about Madame Moody. He's definitely demented in the head, but he can be sentimental.
Yeah.
He has a heart.
Also symbolism. But yeah, okay.
Raining in Scotland, wow.
But yeah, going back to what you're saying about Draco, Pedro, that is another issue with some of the movies past Harry Potter 3 when they cut stuff out. A lot of the stuff that gets axed is Malfoy's development, ironically. Which, you know, wouldn't hurt in the short term. It's just when we come to book 7 that it really hurts.
There you go. Cedric puts also his name into it.
All right. Whoever wins gets a guaranteed up in career post this franchise.
Yeah.
Which means, of course, that Cedric is fucked. As we know from hindsight.
What are you saying, Pedro? A lot of other people got great careers after the franchise. Yeah.
Like Daniel Radcliffe.
So,
like, I mean, who's doing...
Basically, the Weasley twins are basically trying hijack the...
They're trying to cheat.
So basically, there's an AIDS line there that Dumbledore himself made.
Uh-huh.
So basically they're thinking that Dumbledore wouldn't bother to put that kind of thing in because they think that they wouldn't be that stupid.
Dwebs, you're the Harry Potter expert. Were those two twins dropped as babies? Like, did their mom accidentally drop them?
Okay.
Caused brain damage.
There you go.
To Fred and George's credit, they're actually pretty clever. The problem is that they're also mischief makers.
Heck, they managed to make a good career out of being doofuses, so...
Yeah.
Fight!
To be fair, this was a thing in the schools I went to, so I can't complain here.
Hi, Crom.
If anything, it makes it all more relatable.
Why did they all turn around even though he hadn't walked in the room yet?
Mm. It's imposing.
Because I'm the serious guy. Don't you see?
But I'm also the
pretty one. So, of course, Hermione suddenly gets the hots for me for some reason.
Okay. This again goes to my slight complaint about stuff like Crom. Again. I guess you could maybe tell from the movie, but I don't know. It feels a bit awkward. I mean, again, as someone who read the book, I got that this was some big important guy. It's just before this point, we just get like the one point where he's brought up during the World Cup,
boy,
and that's
here
it.
We go.
But what else? Now let's go on to actually hearing the names.
This is one of the most
goblet.
Known scenes of the movie for very good reasons, but will happen near the end of it.
Good reason.
Well, it is.
All right.
I love this goblet. I want to marry it.
It's theatric, do you?
Yeah, well, considering the direction Michael Gambon was given in this film.
First one.
What a shock!
What a surprise!
I'm so shocked!
You actually got to know before.
Somewhat.
Well, at the very least, the one when we know the major name. Yeah. Next
and
one.
And now for Beauxbatons.
Now, they actually do build her up in the book before this point, but I guess it's fine here, since we do get to know her better after this point in the movie anyway, so
plus
I'm not as sore about that.
And the one of Hogwarts is...
Yay! Robert Pattinson!
Knows as he know his career is about to be doomed.
What are you saying? Being in a Harry Potter film often means you have a good career ahead of you.
You know what? You're right. I'm sure I'm misremembering shit, and he's fine.
So, essentially, you're risking life and limb for a big trophy.
Which I've got a replica of. Well, not like a that kind of quality, where it goes a plastic toy, but still.
Oh, right.
Sports are not worth
but
you
Snape
dying.
Snape is perceiving something wrong with the Force.
But Shiroi, where is the fun in that, then?
Although, I guess, to be fair, in the book, they do mention that there is prize money as well.
It's no fun. Oh, yeah, there's a lot of prize money. They never mention it here, I don't think. But yeah, there's a lot of prize money.
Actually, wasn't there like a subplot where Fred and George tried to get some gold from leprechauns, but it was counterfeit?
I'll go more into that subplot later.
We'll mention that later.
But unfortunately, yeah. Alright, just listen to this for a second. Nope. I'll explain more. Thanks, Hagrid.
Oh.
You're in trouble.
Why do people hate me and put me in and drag me into these things?
Why does the universe hate me?
And for some reason, Ron becomes a major jerk towards Harry.
Oh, more on that later.
We'll get to that later. But
yeah, I admit, I never understood this thing about him getting hot. Why didn't you tell him you did it? But because I don't have to tell you everything, asshole. Like,
I'm sorry, I didn't do it.
So,
but even if he did, Dwibs, who exactly says that he has to tell Ron everything? He's not allowed his privacy.
They go
I get the whole best friends tell each other everything kind of deal, but come on.
Snape is confused.
Yeah, but McGonagall's at least trying here.
Yeah.
And Moody's enjoying this.
I don't know what Moody is thinking. Oh boy.
Oh boy, here we go. Nice looking
and
room, though.
Psychotic.
Than trophies.
You French star.
Everything
and
is a conspiracy.
Psychotic performance
theory.
In 5, 4.
Oh, here it
three,
is.
3, 2, 1, go. Dumbledore, what the
for
heck
context,
are you doing?
Context, I wouldn't even make such a fuss of it. The internet will not say such a fuss of it, but it's explicitly said in the book. Literally, he asked calmly.
Yeah,
like however. Apparently, from interviews and everything, this was supposedly was a scene that they had to take a lot of times. So apparently, this was a result of actors being very annoyed by this point.
So it's kind of like if people turned into Christian Bale during Terminator Salvation.
Yeah, okay. I'll get one thing straight and out of the way. Because Michael Gambon didn't perform Dumbledore at all in this way in the previous movie, and in future movies either. I mean, there was a little bit of anger, but they're with it to this extent. So I'm just going to say, I'm going to blame Mike Newell, since he was the director. He told him to act that way, and we'll leave it at that.
All right.
So your dad doesn't bother to stop him.
So even if the system was rigged, they don't really have a choice.
Okay.
Yeah,
This is admittedly an issue I've had with both the book and the movie. Okay, so Harry's name is in, and the Goblet of Fire apparently can't be reignited until the next tournament. Ignoring how silly that is, why not just not let him compete?
Again, it's a binding magical contract. For all I mean, what if I keep doing compete and like the Goblet of Fire blew up and killed everybody?
That's the thing, they never mentioned that.
McGonagall is agreeing with you, Jovan.
That's the thing, Dwibs. It's literally just, what a shock. It's the Ministry of Magic forcing their stupid rules that push this stuff. And don't worry. I don't let this ruin the sorcery. It's just, man, the Ministry of Magic could put stupid governments to shame.
How has the wizarding community survived up until this point?
That's the biggest question I've been asking myself a long time. They need to keep the facade in order to stay away from the muggles, and at the same time having all of these rules.
Despite the fact that they do let muggles into their families, unlike the American wizarding government, like at least the American wizarding government is consistent.
Oh yeah, foreshadowing for book 6.
Oh yeah, Pensieve. I believe at this time, at least book 6 was out. Not quite sure if book 7 was made. Yeah, believe it or not, folks, the Harry Potter movies did in fact start before J.K. Rowling was even done
also,
with the movie.
Also, McGonagall's right. I mean, no one follows the rules any other time. Why now suddenly?
Because
you gotta go, let's just watch this. It'll be fun.
Because Barty Crouch, and yeah, that's a thing. Barty Crouch isn't even the head of the Ministry of Magic. He's the head of their games division. Yeah, there's apparently a games division for the Ministry of Magic.
Hey, Harry is even saying, I didn't want this to happen.
Okay.
Also, Shiro, about the whole dying games thing, think of it like a video game.
Okay.
Well, this was a video game.
Okay. Ron being stupid here was also in the book. Here is where I bring back my point as to why cutting a lot of certain scenes were stupid. In the book, there were actually scenes that built up on this sort of stuff. In the book, we had more scenes explaining more and whatnot here and there. I'm going to bring it up a few times, and like I said, it doesn't even ruin the movie fully for me. This is still one of my more liked Harry Potter movies. Screw you, Ron.
Good night to you, too.
But yeah, again, I get that they have to cut some scenes. It's just the scenes they cut help facilitate scenes like this better. And oh no, God.
They also cut a lot about her as well.
Time for some stereotypical journalism.
Not so much stereotypical. She's actually a spinning image, but I digress. Rita Skeeter, the Daily Prophet.
Who plays her?
Let me check in a second. Miranda Richardson.
Oh, I've heard of her before.
I did as well. Let me check.
Okay, I gotta say, starting with book 4, J.K. Rowling really liked to make other people we were gonna hate aside from Voldemort.
Jova, she voiced the protagonist of The King and I, the girl protagonist of The King and I.
Oh dear.
The animated one.
Yep.
Maybe Warner Brothers had her on speed dial or something.
I mean, she's a good actress, but
she was also
yeah.
in the Phantom of the Opera movie, Chicken Run, Sleepy Hollow.
Miss Keeter,
are you trying to seduce me?
So for Harry in particular, she wants a private interview in a cupboard.
Ouch.
Did you catch that bit? It's a proof cupboard, do you?
No.
Like, by the only issue of the tournament,
yes,
Harry is still a minor, technically.
I'm starting to question.
Yes.
Which one is the specific place for Harry to be in? His Muggle family's house or Hogwarts? I'm starting to wonder which one is the safest place.
Amen.
Well, by the study of book 5, not even the Dursley's house is a safe place anymore. So
He should just go to America. They know how to deal with this stuff.
Okay, let me rephrase that then.
Yeah, between these two, I get it. Yeah, Hogwarts is definitely the last safe place.
Oh, no, but I think I have a better way of expressing that. Who treats him worse, the Dursleys or the wizard that he's supposed to belong to?
Dursleys.
Dursleys.
Like, don't get me wrong. Don't get me wrong. All the wizards here treat him like this.
Hogwarts puts him in more danger, but the Dursleys basically keep him on the prison.
Let me put it like this. If the Dursleys didn't care for him as family, they'd have probably have let him die from starvation. Like, at the very least, I can buy that people here care for him.
The ghost of my past.
Oh, God.
Are you writing a news report or a fan fiction?
Okay. It's kind of a shit. Oh, God, that's another thing I don't like. Her comeuppance gets cut out of the movie.
It does? I don't know. Like, at the end.
That's okay. Someone else doesn't.
Lots of bird droppings.
Is that wrong?
Well, this is the owlery. This is the owlery, so.
Filch doesn't clean this place often enough.
Okay, now this is one circumstance where it was understandable why there wasn't as much as serious in the film as there was in the book, because at the same year this film came out, Batman Begins came out.
And Gary Oldman was busy being Commissioner Gordon.
So, yeah, serious is only in two scenes in this movie.
Was he in the
whatever,
book?
I'm thinking...
Again, he was in. I think he was in more of the book. It's just they couldn't use.
Well,
he
doesn't appear in person. He still has these letters which communicates with Harry. So I think it's fine enough.
Plus, he's a face in the fire.
Honestly, yeah, that's all I really remember for him in the book. Aside from maybe a scene where he shows up physically, but they obviously couldn't include that. But yeah, he wasn't even that much in the book. And oh boy, here we go.
Oh, God, this reviews.
Journalism is bad for you. What a surprise.
Age Wait, 12. Age 12? He's 14!
I know, he even said to her, I'm 14.
So Harry Potter is Dick Grayson now.
Yes, Harry Potter, age 12.
Harry even told her, I'm 14.
Oh, there we go. Speaking of Gary Oldman.
Here we go.
Yeah. Yeah. I got it. Commissioner Gordon was trying to give a communique to Batman, but his call got diverted.
What are you, dense? What are you, stupid or something, Harry? I'm the goddamn Voldemort.
All right, the dream.
You know,
yeah, the beginning scene, yeah.
This effect is actually pretty good, you know, his face in the fire, so why is it worse in the next film?
Oh.
Wait, hold on. He does that again in the next film?
He's in the next film and he talks him through the fireplace, but the effect there is worse.
Huh. I don't recall.
You'll find out in the next film.
Yeah. Yes, Harry, in this world where you've had
totally.
Premonitions from your scar, a snake
like,
that can get through the dreams and talk to you,
yeah,
dementors,
ago,
time travel, and everything, I'm sure a dream just means nothing. Yeah.
Implying.
Was it safe in the first place?
Pedro, did I miss a scene where Hogwarts was ever safe?
Honestly,
maybe
Joe,
in that RPG that's supposed to come out. Maybe it's safe there. I don't fucking know.
According to the mobile game, Hogwarts wasn't even safe even way years before Harry came out in. So,
Jova, at this point, I've just come to accept that the Muggle definition of safe and the wizard definition of safe is considerably
different.
Yeah. Also, Sirius has just revealed that the headmaster of Durmstrang used to be a Death Eater.
Oops.
You know, Dumbledore, one thing you could try doing sometimes is make sure you don't hire teachers who look clearly suspicious for some reason or other.
I forget, though. I think that was the Ministry's decision to hire Mad-Eye Moody.
Okay. Remind me again, just in case I forgot. Was Dumbledore aware that the guy from the previous movie was a werewolf?
Yes.
Then why did he hire him?
Okay. To his credit, they did put in an arrangement that he would have a special potion that would allow him to keep control during his transformations, which he kept except for that one night. And to
he was away for so long. He went after Harry and everyone, basically.
Oh, bless you, Neville. Yeah.
He also took, I believe in the books, he also took breaks, but he told the students he was unwell. They didn't know. Only Hermione figured it out.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, now, one thing I do like about this film is this starts Neville's...
character growth, yeah.
Yeah. And thankfully
he's
the movie keeps this
intact. He's less of the comic relief and now actually a decent character.
And I will give credit to the movie, they keep this intact, so that's good.
Also, yeah, apparently Ron and Harry's friendship has deteriorated so much that Hermione's the messenger girl.
This is the scene that I don't like because it's... petty, like the way they both use Hermione to communicate each other.
And
this is how schoolgirls behave stereotypically.
Like I get it, they're angsty teenagers. They're clearly not knowing what they're doing, but
this is preteen behavior. And again, in the book, we at least got more build up to their relationship deteriorating. But here we got one scene fighting,
the
and
Ron,
now we're here.
The Ron and but you're his. That's charming of you.
Hypocrite.
I get the deterioration between Ron and Harry's friendship. That one is fine. It's just this scene where they used Hermione to speak to each other. It's just...
That's exactly my point. It's like, well, I mean, again, the book has scenes of their relationship getting worse to that point, but here it's just, it's gotten that worse. And, oh yeah, Hagrid also has a crush.
found these charming.
Shame the movie takes an axe to this as well, but I digress. At least they show some of it.
Oh.
Yeah. Raw.
Oh, by the way, we're in the Forbidden Forest again. Better hope Aragog doesn't hear about that spider being used in a lesson.
Again, at this point, it's really established that the Forbidden Forest is chock full infested of spiders.
And yet, for some reason, Hogwarts constantly uses it for this reason or that.
But that's the problem, Jova. As we will learn, I think in the fifth book, in the fifth story, basically, there is also a reason why we can just burn the place down. Come on.
Aw, this is adorable.
Let me check who plays. Olympe Maxime. There we go. Frances Deltour.
So here's the deal. The first challenge, which is supposed to be a secret to every single student, is dragons.
And she's a fan of dragons, it seems.
Great starts.
Oh, c'est la mini, c'est magnifique.
Oh, she was in Mr. Holmes.
Yep, she's also in Into the Woods.
Hugo, also.
Yeah.
Except for that one. Basically, the Horntail is the meanest, biggest, and nastiest of the dragons. Guess who gets that one?
Oh, apparently, and Ron never told.
Yeah, his big brother Charlie, who sadly we don't get to meet in the movie. But...
Oh well.
Oh well. How sad. Well, Harry...
Yeah, but again, you know, Ron hates Harry now.
Well, Harry, that's very disappointing. Oh, never mind. I guess we're going to this scene now.
Propaganda. Sorta.
Okay, this is built up more on than the book, but all you need to know is that essentially Malfoy made some buttons that basically mock Harry, but praise Cedric.
Doesn't he have anything better to do with his fucking life?
No, Teo, because he's a bully, and that's what bullies do.
Also, and of course the teachers aren't going to do dick all about any of this.
Actually, Shiroi, maybe it's just because, again, in my country it's different, but from having grown up in the 90s in Portugal, this is very relatable to me.
Oh, yeah.
I'm afraid to say, because teachers back in the day didn't do jack squat.
Oh, no, they didn't do jack squat in my school either.
See,
so the whole anti-bullying shit that didn't exist at the time.
So, okay, can I just point out a bit of a weird thing I've always found with the series? Like, remember how Harry was pretty much a celebrity who everyone loved, except for obviously Slytherins in like the first two books.
Well, now we're acting like as a citizens of the Marvel universe. So.
Now, okay, look, at least in the first Harry Potter book, it made sense when they hated him when he kind of messed up Gryffindor's chances for getting the House Cup until they thankfully managed to get a nice rebound with some extra points. And in book two, yeah, there was the whole talking to the snake thing, which got some people here. However, with book four, starting with book four, it felt like J.K. Rowling was trying to beat him down by having everyone hate him from book after book. Trust me, it gets worse in book five. Uh-oh.
Ooh.
Pathetic.
There you go.
Someone's doing something.
Yeah, you asked for the teachers doing something. Had a cute weasel. I think it... Oh, God.
Ferret.
Or a mongoose? Ferret, there you go. Oh, yeah, ferret.
Poor ferret, though.
Just dropped
it.
Yeah. Oh, Malfoy, stay out of Crab's pants there. I didn't know you went that way.
Instant shipping.
Crab's a furry.
What did you see in there?
Oh, get the shit out of you.
Which is it? Okay. Verb. Also, bit of an extra detail, but in the book, he actually gets to give Malfoy detention on top of that.
Ah, my back. Teaching students a lesson is painful.
Oh yeah, by the way, we talked a bit over it, but Harry actually did a nice thing and told Cedric that the first challenge is dragons.
Yeah, basically warned Cedric about the dragon.
I mean, Cedric even said, I don't want him to wear the badges, but... And then I was like, yeah, don't worry.
How fitting. The only person who's not being a dick to him like that
is
Cedric.
His rival in the tournament, yeah.
He's not kidding.
Whoever's in there must be feeling a little bit moody at the moment.
Very funny, man. I'm moody. Very funny. All right.
So Harry has to find a strategy against the dragon because he's not a proper fighter.
I'm sure you'd make a lovely fairy princess. What are you talking about?
You know, Mad-Eye Moody, there's a certain meme going around that probably has fan art of you at this point.
Yeah, what are you good at, Harry?
Is this a job interview now? Jesus.
Yes.
And you can do a lot with a wand.
Wing.
Hint, hint, nudge, nudge. Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah, again, yeah, this score makes the whole film worth it.
Yeah. Wait, oh, I take it you're not a big fan of the film, Dibs?
Oh, no, 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 no. I'm not saying I'm not a fan of the film. I mean, but I don't think it's one of the stronger ones, but the score does help.
That's understandable. And I'll admit, I really do like the competition costumes.
They look like something you see in, like, an American high school.
Who's there? Oh, Hermione.
That's not how this joke works, Hermione.
I overheard Dumbledore's announcement. Yeah, please keep your seat. This will minimize any risk you're exposed to. Yeah, sure. Sit on these wooden seats with fire-breathing dragons. There will be no risk whatsoever.
Aww.
Oh, God.
But she's a shipper.
But hey, Crumb's... Crumb's gonna give her what... Well, verbally, what for?
He talks.
Literally, be gone, fought.
Yeah. Bye.
He said it a bit more politely, though.
All right, time to check how the dragons will be assigned to each other.
Basically, at this point, everyone knows what that challenge is going to be, thanks to one reason or another.
Yeah. Bye, Hermione.
Bye.
It's funny, Barty's probably the only one who doesn't know that they know.
Okay, the first dragon is... Oh, sure, a dragon from your country.
How cute. And it's adorable.
But why isn't it red?
They just called it the Welsh Green.
Oh, come on, you don't show me a Chinese dragon.
Yeah, I want to see that.
We ran out of effects budget.
Lucky. Ah! Never mind.
Nothing.
Have fun, Harry.
I said, oh, homrail. That's a magical, it's a new curse word I made.
But if it's any consolation, they get to keep the mini dragons afterwards. Which, now that I think about it, what exactly are those? Are those replicas, or are those actually tiny dragons themselves?
From what I can, from considering his choice of words, they're basically not holograms, but the magic equivalent.
Which is weird, because they can physically bite.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah, that's a running gag. Filch jumping the gun when it comes to firing the cannon.
Jumping the gun?
Literally, in this case, the cannon.
He interprets a hand signal as simple as the cue.
And poor Harry's the last one. No one
so it's like that scene in Asterix and Mansion of the Gods where they keep misinterpreting the signal.
We want to assure you there is no possible way a student can die. Wow.
Of course, Harry's the last one to do it.
Well, like I just said, I mean, no one wants to be the last in any situation, let alone this.
Nope.
So yes, now it's Harry's turn to undertake the first task of the Quadrizard Tournament.
So essentially, the challenge is to the student to get an egg. Simple. Here's the problem. It's against a mother dragon. Who thinks it's her egg?
And this one is apparently a bit of a bitch.
Oh yeah, the horntail is considered the biggest and worst of the variants they brought.
Okay, just tiptoe my way to the egg.
Surprise!
Big mistake.
Oh. Hi. Come here often?
No.
Oh, well, I must say, you're pretty hot.
Don't take my egg. Plenty of males have already tried to use more swooning details towards me.
No, but that's not your egg.
Says who? I can tell it. It looks just fine, all red and nice.
Since when do dragons shit out gold eggs?
Well, Mother told me I was very extra special.
I think this is actually the plot point where the subplot of Fred and George using leprechaun's gold happens.
Not quite, Theo. That's actually...
Just not referencing the book. Not here, just in the book, I think.
Okay, Theo, I'll just let you know right now. The leprechaun gold has to do with the Quidditch World Cup thing.
All right.
But again, more on that later.
It's really a minor thing anyway. It just happens referenced at the end anyway.
Yeah,
but anyway, Harry, there you go, using... a simple spell of attracting objects, he gets his broom here.
Basically, it's the spell Asio.
I thought we banned brooms!
No, you only... Actually, no, you didn't ban one,
we
so that's
to
a spell.
Bring it, yeah, didn't say we could call it.
So yes, we finally get to see the firebolt in action.
About time.
Oh, after and look at that, the dragon is free of the chains!
Yeah.
Great job on that security work!
Who built the chains? Yeah, again, sit down, you'll be totally safe.
Oh, okay.
He just nearly died.
Well, okay. It knocked into Snape and Rita Skeeter, so good on her.
Okay. Well, I would thank you very much for giving our teachers a nice scare. I am nowhere near your egg, so if you could please leave me alone.
No! You challenged the nest, now you're going to be dinner for the rest!
Huh.
Rest? But you don't have any other kids.
Oh, no. When that child hatches out of that golden egg, you're going straight to his or her mouth after I regurgitate you.
Ew.
Good. She can't see me.
So, what now, Harry?
Okay, she can't see me. No,
I'm just hanging out, I guess.
Oh, it's good enough that the broom just landed near him.
Boy, Hogwarts is gonna have fun patching this stuff up.
Headcanon, Filch is the one who has to repair every single tie.
Poor bastard.
Okay. I will give the movie credit. This is actually a lot more exciting than how the challenge room went in the book. Like, in the book, it was just he simply grabs it up quickly because the fireballs are so fast. But here, we actually get a bit more of a challenge and venture out to the school grounds.
I mean, after all, Harry's still, like, against a dragon, not, like, a simple goblin.
You know, I actually suddenly feel bad for Filch. I mean, he's the janitor. Imagine having to clean up after all the shit that happens at this school. No wonder he's so grumpy.
You know, he's loved by students because he's terrible to them.
Well, maybe if they didn't literally destroy the school, he might be a bit less grumpy.
And movie-wise, he's even luckier because he doesn't even have to deal with Peeves.
Okay, I don't
pay him enough.
I know my broom's called the Firebolt, but this is ridiculous.
Slow down, nuts in the pot, whatever you are, I've got you. Oh, not.
Ah.
Ow!
You could have gone
over me as a guardian mother!
Also, I just want to point out that the dragon disappeared between frames.
The mother dragon is really clumsy.
I guess she's dead.
Wah-wah-wah-wah-wah-wah.
Oh, hey, look, it's that guy who announced the Quidditch World Cup. He's kind of more the focus in the book, but not so much the focus here. I digress.
Don't you think they could have put up a screen or something? Because this isn't a very good spot to watch.
Hermione's happy.
It's like Formula One, where basically you're stuck at one part of the loop
track,
and you have the track. And there you go.
Yay!
I got the chocolate egg.
Even the paintings
are
happy.
I'm suddenly friends with you again.
Yeah, totally.
So,
So what's inside the egg?
It's a clue for the next challenge.
Okay.
It's nice to see Harry get a legit moment of joy. He needs more of those.
And...
Unfortunately, the clue is a bit of an ear sore.
I mean, I'm just grateful that we didn't use this to do a cheap jump scare.
Hey, Ron. Now you think.
You know what? Fuck you all.
So let me get
I'm
this
moving
straight.
To Hufflepuff.
Yes, sir, Vader.
Yes.
So let me get this straight. You preferred to trust the word of others outside of your best friend.
Yeah, Ron does not really have a good look in the fourth installment.
Okay. Since we're constantly talking about things that they left out from the book, how about leaving this subplot out of the movie to insert others?
Yeah, I agree. Either they needed
it's going
to
nowhere.
Whether or not this was in the book,
it was done.
It's just a waste of our time.
It was
it's
done better in the
Hollywood
book,
mentality,
but yeah.
That simple conflict is just enough.
This is again one of my issues with what they chose to adapt and what not to. Again, this is by no means my least favorite Harry Potter movie. In fact, I really do like it still. It's just, this is quite possibly the most baffling adaptation in the works. I mean, like Pedro said, it's just as... Actually, no, it's even more pointless in the movie than it is the book. Oh, speaking of pointless subplots,
Cho
Chang,
still Harry Potter related. Who else has been to the Harry Potter studio tour in London?
Sadly, not.
I haven't.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it?
So who has been to the Harry Potter theme park in Universal Studios, which has actual stuff used from the film sets, including...
I have.
Yeah. Great thing about Universal Studios, they even managed to get some actual props from the movies, too.
So wait, Rita, you construct an article with a photo of Harry hugging Hermione, then you say that Hermione is in love with Victor Crumb. What's your logic?
She's trying to stir up the drama by suggesting that she's cheating on Harry.
One ship at a time, that's the rule.
Tio, it's the perfect marketing drama. Suggest that she's cheating on a celebrity with another guy and oh my god, Robert Pattinson was in this movie.
Yes.
It's kind of odd knowing what happens later. Oh boy.
Oh, it's the virgin killing sweater.
Don't you see, Joe? But Kristen Stewart was perfectly embodying the character of Bella
Oh,
Swan.
God.
A cheating, lying bitch.
Yeah, poor Robert.
Basically, since it's a school, we need a ball scene. There's going to be a ball, and
actually,
people have to dress up appropriately.
Yeah.
Now that I think about it, yeah. Most perfect casting ever. Yeah.
Okay. Now. The Yule Ball thing, I think this is what needed to be cut out of the movie the most. I never liked it in the book, and I don't like it here.
Basically,
it
the Yule...
goes nowhere. All it does is just...
At Christmas Eve.
All this does is just show, they're not good at dancing.
Hey, you know those events that kind of shame you for not having a date? Yeah, this is pretty much Hogwarts' equivalent to that. Apparently the Yule Ball is something... I forget. Is it specifically attached to the Triwizard Tournament?
It is, because she said, McGonagall said it's tied to the guest as well.
Apparently, you are expected to have a date to the point where they are literally having practice lessons, taking time out of school when we could be learning spells to learn how to dance.
To be fair, if there's a person of which anyone would have to learn about to dance properly, that's Maggie Smith.
Oh, yeah.
Babbling, bumbling band of baboons. Maggie, One thing I appreciate, like, about Maggie Smith is she's able to deliver lines like that with such
Remember, Viv, she's part of the old school of actors, of the British actors that got raised through theaters in a time where movies were.
Shakespearean and that, yeah.
Yeah. So basically, she's a trooper, like Angela Lansbury, for example.
I gotta say, Maggie Smith is one of those few actors or actresses who I don't think I've ever cringed seeing her say any line. And trust me, she said a lot of stupid lines considering some roles she's had to play.
I mean,
even as a senile grandma in Nagy in Nanny McPhee 2.
Yeah, but I haven't seen Downton Abbey, but
I don't know even what it is about, but
Not
to mention, he mentioned in a lot of interviews that McGonagall is one of her favorite roles still, so apparently she really enjoys this as a form of entertaining the young audiences.
All right, boys and girls, pair up with your inevitable ships.
Oh, Neville, he's such a dream.
Yeah, unfortunately, Luna Lovegood isn't in the series yet.
Neville is the cinnamon roll of this franchise.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Pax.
Well, girls seem to, for some reason. Oh, God. The cold stare of disappointment.
Nah, Ravenclaw aren't interested,
okay,
Harry.
Okay. Here's where I have to really puzzle myself here. You're telling me that Harry Potter, the Harry Potter, has trouble finding a date. Now, granted, yes, I know that he wants Cho Chang in particular. But there are girls who actually don't seem interested in him. Like, again...
Well, I guess it's a decision of trying not to make him too much of a Gary Stu.
So, okay. Here's the thing, though. He's literally a celebrity. Like, you know, this is one of the few cases where it makes sense.
Just like Victor himself about, yes, Pedro?
So, the moral here is, signing up.
Okay.
You want a romance? There you go.
I'll admit, these two are still adorable. Basically, this is Hagrid's backstory we're getting about how his dad was a human and his mother was a giant.
That's why he's not that tall. Go on, Pedro.
Oh, for God's sakes.
Actually, the way this scene is shot and lighted, this looks a lot like a Twilight movie right now.
Yeah, it does, actually.
Again, Robert Pattinson.
Anyway, okay. So the moral here is sign up for death games and that will get you chicks.
Because
they like jocks and bad boys and shit.
I don't know. Harry Potter signed up for them and he's apparently had trouble getting a date.
Also, Snape's contribution of a movie Ron read.
Apparently Neville actually has someone.
Jobba, I think there's a misunderstanding between the two of us. When I say gets you chicks, I didn't mean dating.
Oh, you like poultry?
Yeah, let's go with that.
I kid. Also, Angelina, she's awesome in the Quidditch games. Don't worry, she'll come later to a head in
your tempting fate.
I believe she's she's a bigger focus in the book version of Order of the Phoenix.
Yes, very well spotted, Ron. I agree. Like,
thanks,
okay.
Say, Hermione, you're a girl, so clearly you know everything about every single girl thinks.
Oops. Turns out Hermione's already taken.
Ron, you have a terrible way with women. I'm sorry.
He does.
Another thing. I mean, if we were mentioning pointless conflict earlier with Ron and Hermione, the old ball causes conflict between Ron,
uh-oh,
Harry, and Hermione.
That's so, weird.
Well, Shiro, you yourself have said that.
Well, you shouldn't be talking during exam time.
Yes, Pedro?
Well, Shiro, you yourself have said that women are tough to deal with, so...
Okay, I am one, I can say that.
I really love this track. But two, I mean, this... Again, the whole thing, it causes tension between Hermione and the others, but again, they just make up off screen afterwards. So.
And how about some special mention?
What exactly is the point of this?
And again, special mention goes to Cho Chang, an arc in the making, but I'll bring it up when we get to book 5.
Look, Ron and Harry, just play video games with them. That worked for me.
Do video games exist in this universe? Well, yes, actually they do, but yeah, that's a good point.
I guess it's a good thing that this series was invented still in the early 2000s because I can't imagine this kind of franchise dealing with things like smartphones.
Okay, for those
The
of
series
you.
takes place during the 90s.
Okay, those of you who are new to the Harry Potter franchise probably don't know what it was like, but let me put it like this. Back in the day when we were at book four in both the books and the movies, a lot of people were thinking that Cho Chang and Harry Potter were going to be a thing considering the little
I mean,
eggs that
canon
J.K.
ship, though,
Rowling
that's
laid
what,
for them. Let's just say, though, that ship went on the rails, off the train tracks, and then,
Right into a
well,
canyon.
finally
yeah.
got sunk for
Let
good.
me put it like this. It's a case where J.K. Rowling doesn't always plan that well ahead.
It's a good thing.
Anyway.
It's actually probably you know what's interesting?
Oh, wait, hold on. This is actually an important detail where we finally get on about it.
Blur.
So he asked Fleur de Cour, one of the champions. You drew?
High on this line here.
Okay.
He ran. Oh, hello, twins. By the way, one of those twins, I believe, is a Ravenclaw. So, what are you doing in here?
They switched it around because
So, essentially.
Harry, I'm here. You could console
Also,
me.
it's
What?
adorable
Your
how
friendship has
they.
broken.
I adore.
Harry?
It's adorable how they. I adore how they basically adorn the pirate ship with the Christmas decorations.
So
Yeah,
apparently.
you mentioned smartphones earlier too.
Oh my god. The fashion police. No one could save you.
Yes,
Look,
Pedro.
okay, Rupert. You're not Hugh Glory. You probably should try a. You probably
Something
should try a
else.
different outfit. Yeah.
Yeah.
Anyway, you mentioned smartphones too.
Yeah.
That whole thing about Joe. When Joe was talking about the whole ship with what's her name again?
Cho
Chang.
No, no,
Oh,
no,
Cho
no, no, no,
Chang.
no. Ari and the
Cho
Chinese
Chang.
Cho
girl, Cho
Chang.
Chang. That's it. That's it. Yeah, that's another thing too. I'm more concerned for the fact that if this movie was made today. Probably there would be a lot of pointless controversy about how the people, how J.K. Rowling is apparently against interracial relationships and stuff like that. So that's another
Possible.
possible thing that
Possibly
fortunately
cons.
got avoided at least.
Oh, interesting fact about this movie. Apparently, the D
Sorry, could you
Guinness
repeat that,
World Record.
Dribs?
Apparently, when this one was released on, it holds the Guinness World Record for being the selling D of all time.
Okay.
Also, this is Pavarotti and her sister. Okay, Dwibs, what was Pravati's sister's name?
Pravati and
Avada Kedavra.
Oh, Patil. It's kind of a shame because they actually do get more focus on the books.
Even McGonagall can't be nice about those robes.
Padma and Parvati Patil.
Ah.
So I'm guessing that twin got the short end of the stick. Okay.
Yeah.
What, the
Oh,
one
look
who's
at
in
that.
Ravenclaw?
Cho Chang got
Cho
Ed.
Chang got Robert Pattinson. Well,
Oh, the irony.
as Hermione.
Oh, Hermione, who's your
You're
date?
practicing for Beauty and the Beast, I see.
She doesn't sing it. Well, I've seen the film. I know she doesn't sing it.
Thank
Fortunately,
God.
not.
I love you, Emma
Don't get
Watson.
me
You
wrong.
were
I
a
don't think
great
she.
actress, but.
Don't get me wrong. She's not like horrible. I don't think. I know that some people do think she's
Still have
horrible
to
in it,
see it
but
properly.
I do. One of these days I'll show you. But anyway, she's not horrible. It's just that she's no Paige O'Hara. Definitely no Paige O'Hara.
She's just like an
Also,
average singer. Like
props.
she couldn't be a singer, but she can't she it, she can sing,
Okay,
Also,
okay, okay.
props to Victor's uniform. That's actually really cool.
And going back to what Dweeb said, yes, I flipping love the music here. Like, yeah, definitely the music for this movie is definitely stellar. In fact, it hasn't had to rely on the typical Harry Potter tune yet.
I still prefer the previous movie score.
Ron.
If your jealousy could show any more, you'd be as green as the Wicked Witch of the West.
Ron, drop your man pride.
Well, I did say at the beginning that I think this is the best non-John Williams score in the series.
Yeah, and I agree.
But Shiroi, a pride is all a man's got.
Pavarti, are you trying to seduce
me? If you took away my pride, what's left of me exactly?
Harry.
I don't know. You'll have to find something.
Harry may suck at dancing, though.
It's a simple waltz, Harry. Come on, you can
improvise. Well, to be fair, we don't want to risk coming close Gary's 2 territory now, do we?
Shiri, remind me about this. Is Mr. Filch's cat always had red eyes?
I think so.
Didn't remember that.
Remember, look at that. Neville and Ginny. Remember when people thought Neville and Ginny were going to be a thing?
I know that she got petrified for a beat in Chamber of Secrets, but man.
Remember,
dude,
Tim,
Mad-Eye, it's a bit early to get drunk, depressed, and boozed at the party.
Yes, Pedro?
Remember, Tim, we're treading on thin ice, both literally and figuratively, so we have to be careful with the Garish 2 possibility.
True.
Now let's bring in the Weird Sisters, who are actually kind of a war. They actually are kind of a running movie.
Sorry, Jova, due to copyright reasons and a call, we can't call them.
So was that supposed to be the one rock band in the Wizarding world?
Yeah, there are others, but
Led by pulp lead singer Jarvis Cocker.
Jarvis what?
Jarvis Cocker.
Like the dog breed.
No comment.
It's like the dog breed.
Yes.
Ooh.
Buzzing?
Wow.
Okay, that was funny. Arm, leg, I'm yours.
So, yeah, you know, it's a shame. Parvati and Padme, I think they had bigger roles in the books. Okay, Parvati probably had a bigger role. I'm not quite sure about her sister.
Yeah. Are we sure we can't fast forward this bit?
No.
Yeah. Skip.
Again, this is my issue with the adaptation. Why did we have to leave this cringeworthy stuff? Especially the fact that Victor's never going to get brought up again in the movies. I mean, okay, at least in the books, Victor does come back for later ones, but if I recall correctly,
also a bit jarring seeing a British story trying to do a very typical American thing. This ball thing that schools do, that's mostly on America.
Making this tournament's meant to be making big friends.
Yeah.
Not to mention, Webs, if we're going to start skipping over bad parts of movies in these commentaries, our commentary of Adventure of the Fallen would be 0 minutes long.
And don't even get me start. Don't even get me started on how short our commentary of Terminator Salvation would have been.
Yeah.
And how about our commentary of Last Airbender?
Probably should have gone with Cho. The Chinese girl.
Okay. Well, he tried to, but she turned him down because she's going out with Cedric Diggory.
Yeah. By the way, guys, this is never mentioned again.
Okay.
Despite the fact that Ron's seeing a supreme
goes nowhere.
Look, Hermione, aren't you supposed to be...
didn't go anywhere in the...
Whoa, Hermione, why are you getting mad at Harry?
This didn't go anywhere in the book, either.
Oh, maybe. That's right!
I'm tempted to make a certain joke right now, but I'll skip it.
Oh, that's right! I forgot. Now Ron's going to have a not-talking match with Hermione.
Maybe it's hormones, I don't know. But anyway, the point is... Hermione, aren't you supposed to be the strong, independent woman? Why don't you ask him? We don't live in the Middle Ages anymore.
Apparently, she's mad that Ron only decided to ask her as our last resort, as far as she knows.
Angsty teenager, they it's almost, I believe.
Sadly. If Jova's theory holds any weight, then Shiro, I have to turn it back at you. Why doesn't this woman give up her prize?
I got nothing.
Exactly.
And you know, okay, here's the sad thing. After this, it's supposed to be a scene between Hagrid and the headmistress of
Babatons.
Yeah, Babatons. But unfortunately,
But unfortunately,
that touching
my curve.
The problem is, like, well, that touching scene gets replaced with the Kryn scene. It's like,
oh no, we're in a Paranormal Activity movie now, aren't we?
The blurriness is so weird.
Also, I love how they blatantly reuse footage.
Yeah.
They forgot to clean the lens.
Which is weird.
Sorry, Dwibs, we ran out of money, so we had to extend the movie with reused footage, but blurred.
Which is weird, because if I recall correctly, Harry does get different dreams later on in the book anyway, so them reusing this one feels iffy.
Dreamweaver. Well, to be fair...
Yeah, the correct answer.
I got laid, and you didn't. Yep. Suck it,
and
asshole.
And apparently with Ginny.
Yikes.
Yeah, by the way, after this, Neville and Ginny don't...
Actually, isn't there a weird rule in this school where it's like, girls are allowed in the boys' room, but boys aren't allowed in the girls' room?
Yeah, never did get
Excuse
that
me. Like...
Oh boy, and here
we
go.
I'm not sure if that's true. I kind of remember reading that fairly recently. So...
Also, audience, I have bad news. The Hermione versus Ron subplot is continuing.
Not just that.
Harry Potter, the sitcom.
So
I wish.
That's the second movie.
At least...
Shiroi, what you just said might just be the unsafest aspect of Hogwarts as a school. Like
their double standards?
No, the fact that they allow a single girl to go into the men's room, the bedroom.
But not the reverse.
Yeah, because clearly that's a safe thing for a single girl to go into.
Oh,
right?
Don't worry, Pedro.
That's a weird rule.
Don't worry, Pedro, because that gets brought to its logical conclusion in book 6.
Shiroi, is weird whales for a crime waiting to happen?
Welsh.
Yeah, Welsh. Didn't I say
Oh,
Welsh?
Right.
Wait, what about Welsh?
Huh? No, I mean, you said it was a weird rule. Is weird Welsh for incredibly, incredibly dangerous?
Yeah.
Speaking weird language.
Okay, so Cedric's... returning the favor that Harry telling first task, and Cedric's giving Harry a hint about the second task.
Basically, give it a bath.
Water.
And apparently,
oh my god, I can see him practicing for Twilight as well. Because see, one of the things about Robert Pattinson's acting in Twilight is that you'll notice this when we get back to those movies. He's always looking like he's about to pass a kidney stone. Like, and he kind of looked like that right now. Also,
that reminds me, where are we with those movies? I recall we did the first three.
Harry, you are aware that
I'll say later, Joe.
That Myrtle is gonna show up, right?
No, wait.
And watch you as you
bath.
Oh,
right.
To be fair, Pedro, there's no way he could have known that. But here's the weird thing, though.
It's weird when you know how old her actress is.
Yeah,
Shiroi,
compared to Daniel Radcliffe.
Actually, Shiroi, technically her character is hundreds of years old by this point.
Oh,
yeah.
Well, that's the thing, Pedro. As soon as you die, you don't age.
Oh, by the way, guys, at this
Long
point...
Long time
Shirley
no see, Pedro!
Shirley Henderson, who plays Moaning Myrtle, at this point she was 40.
But sorry, Jove, at this point. Sorry.
Yeah, here she is playing a dead 17-year-old.
Wow, I mean, she aged. Well, she still looks like she could be a teenager. How did
she?
She's
52.
Well, remember, Jove, even though she's acting, in the actual screen, it's a CGI effect, so they can change the CGI model to make up for any.
This was an early prototype for that, yeah.
Yeah. But she's 40, though. I mean, that's still some pretty good effects. Although it's weird. In this case, she looks like a gender swap version of Harry. In fact, Moaning Myrtle Why are you out of your bathroom? Oh, that's right, she can choose to.
Also, Joe, about your saying earlier.
Here's the next clue. Oh, we can just pause.
We noticed that.
An hour long.
Why is it always in rhymes? Why?
It's fancy.
To quote 80s from Hercules, verse.
Can we have haikus instead?
Yes.
Actually, Shiroi, I'll take rhymes over haikus, because haikus are too much work. I have to constantly use my fingers to make sure I have the right syllables.
Personal space.
She's a ghost, it won't matter.
How do you know?
Harry looks visibly uncomfortable.
It's okay, I'm 40 years
old. Oh god, don't look there!
Jesus.
You must have been such a pleasure when you were alive. Well, to be fair, she did say that she would love for him to share her toilet with her and... Hey, keep your eyes out!
As for the look of a destroyed man.
As for earlier, Jova, sorry, but at this point the magic is gone.
Really?
Yeah, at this point the long time no see, it's just the magic is gone.
Yeah, I mean,
you're finally cured.
I mean, look, see, Ron and Hermione look like they're interacting just fine.
Hold on. That what Harry just said now. Potentially problematic. There you go. That's the perfect way to describe every single thing that is done in the school.
So,
potentially
yeah.
problematic.
So what was with them falling out of the Yule Ball earlier then?
Don't worry, dudes. They're gonna bring that up again. Stupidly. Now, okay. You know, considering how he... I gotta wonder... Oh, wait. Never mind. I guess it makes sense that they would give him clues so that they can prepare in preparation. So, yeah. To add to the many things of danger in the Harry Potter universe, there are mermaids hanging out in the lake that will happily drown you. They may look cute. They may look cute, but, don't be fooled.
Well, that's typical. Mermaids are freaking bitches. So, yeah.
Unless they're voiced by Jodie Benson.
Well, yeah. And to be fair, yeah.
Gravity-resistant trees.
That was a nice kind of mermaid. But most times in fairy tales, mermaids are usually depicted as...
alluring, trap masters.
There's actually a plant that can allow you to breathe underwater. Okay,
Still doing what you do best.
Yeah, like Tia said, there's one thing this movie definitely does good. It's definitely retaining and exemplifying how Neville is definitely quite useful in this.
By the way, Harry, I got laid and you didn't. I got laid and you didn't.
I don't want to talk about it. But yeah, that is kind of something. Neville got laid before Harry did. The famous Harry Potter.
Oh, by the way, Neville, I've heard rumors about this weird, this out there girl who I'll be seeing apparently next year. You might be a perfect match for her, actually.
Really? What makes you say that?
She's just as out there as you are at times.
I wonder.
Anyway,
but
yeah,
I don't know, Harry. I'm pretty sure
the
things between me and Ginny are going to work out fine.
about that.
Okay,
this is where things will start to get weird.
Let him say it first to you.
Yeah, apparently three students are now drowning.
No, not just three.
Four students are drowning.
Four, sorry.
That's right, Hogwarts let mermaids take students down below underwater.
They took them below some lock in the Black Lake.
Thanks, Fields.
Now here's hoping the gillyweed works.
Okay. Can't we just have a math contest or something for a change?
All right, okay, now this scene was actually properly done underwater. No, yeah. other than the scenery, there was Daniel really.
Oh, this scene.
Yeah, I love this bit.
I've done what Voldemort failed to do! Could you just imagine, though, if that's what had killed Harry Potter?
Again, another situation where where something else would have killed Harry instead of anything Voldemort tied.
Oh, that's such a good point. Jova.
Yeah?
You know one thing in common that says with another franchise? Uh-huh. Harry and friends are constantly getting into situations.
There's a lot of franchises like that.
Again,
I remember, in Alpha and Omega, they flat out say,
"Oh
that.
God."
Okay. Again, why would you make this a spectator's? The spectators can't see anything.
Yeah, that's actually a good point.
I get it, Whips. It's just like in that card game tournament in Yu-Gi-Oh, where Betty Keeve and Pegasus are playing in a normal board without holograms, and yet there's a gigantic stadium crowd there, even though they clearly can see what the fuck is going on. So.
Yeah.
It's even worse than the base.
So the Bubaton student is using actually an air bubble.
But she's crap.
And yeah. Unfortunately, Fleur got caught by something.
Seaweed, my number one.
Okay.
Actually, it's very effective. With kelp offers a good protection against sea creatures.
Ooh. Yeah, Fleur quit.
She got snagged by something that we've yet to see.
Which unfortunately means that the person he was sent to... There. I wonder who that person could be.
I wonder. You know, Hogwarts is a pretty big freaking lake, and there's so much life underneath water here. Like,
One thing I want to bring up, actually.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's in the DVD release earlier. But the special features disc on the DVD version, not the Blu-ray version, unfortunately. The DVD version has the Triwizard Tasks as playable games on the DVD.
Cool. So, yeah.
In the first one, you have to press the button prompt correctly. In the second one, you have to win in the right area. And in the third one, you have to press the right button. Go the right way, pretty much.
So, of course, Cho Chang got kidnapped because... Well, holy cow, I guess she just got kidnapped because Cedric took her out to the ball, so dang...
With obvious looking models.
Ooh.
Oh, okay.
Not the most alluring mermaids.
Yeah, just one.
Yep. Basically.
Everybody gets one.
Ah! Oh my god, Jaws!
Oh.
Nah, it's just Crumb. Apparently, Hermione was the one to. So, okay, these are all people who are close to the champion. So, let's do the rundown. Ron is, of course, Harry's best friend, so that makes sense. But when it comes to Hermione and Cho Chang, they were just the dates for the guys. What, are you telling me that they got that close that much immediately?
Sure, why not?
Unfortunately, that other girl, who is close to Fleur, is in trouble because Fleur's not in the running.
Yeah.
We are Cho safe.
So, of course, Cedric is in the lead.
And the shark has taken Hermione. Oh.
Jesus.
Yeah, Crumb.
So does that mean that Crumb is an animagus on his own?
No, he probably used a spell.
Yeah. Animagus is when you turn into a full one. So somehow Harry gets to take both of these for some reason.
I think the effects of the yard of the weed is...
Well, remember, Joe, but they said only one, and...
Well, now he's taking two, though. I guess the mermaids are okay with this.
Not this lot.
Oh, those are mermaids. Those are... Actually, I have no idea what these were. I don't think these were in the book.
I don't remember. I have the original Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them book, you know, the in-universe book, but I don't remember this one.
So, did you use Stupefy?
But uh-oh, the...
Yay, the people Harry rescued are up, but Harry is...
The effect of the, and the effect of the gillyweed is gone.
Yeah.
Well, oh, well, they speak French at least. Look, 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 look.
That comes in handy.
We do the Superman theme. Yeah. I mean, it's Warner Bros., so we might as well do it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, in the book, it's revealed that apparently the students were never in danger to some accord.
Yeah, I call bullshit.
Yeah, yeah. The movie doesn't even bother with that. Which, so yeah. You knowingly drowned other students just for the champion's sake.
And her sister.
Oh yeah, there was kind of this thing between Ron and Fleur, possibly. Didn't go much places. But Harry, there's a little catch.
A French accent.
Yeah, thank you.
I have a question.
Yes.
By the way.
Wait, hold on.
Bubblehead charm. Yes, Pedro?
Oh, however.
So.
So here's the thing. Harry would have finished first, though. However, he only finished last because he also saved someone else.
So it's Dumbledore pulling once again another reason, however.
It's okay. He's got second place.
Okay. That adds even more to my question. Okay. If Dumbledore can just do whatever the fuck he wants and bend every rule, why can't he just... Okay, you got the... Harry Potter's name came out from the goblet. But you still won't go because I just forbid you to. There you go. Problem solved.
Ministry of Magic unfortunately has some pull there. Okay, folks, sit back and relax because now we're going to have quite a bit of content to go before the third and final challenge.
Also, I believe this was a scene that was also, or rather what happens after this, is something that was very watered down.
In the book or the movie?
The movie.
Oh, yeah, and to kind of its detriment.
It's one of the things they almost kind of brush over after it happened, honestly.
Which is kind of a shame, because Barty Crouch is kind of an important character in the book. That's to say the movie does him dirty.
And if I recall correctly, in the books, he even got replaced off-screen as the Minister of Magic, so...
Oh god, is he the Minister of Magic? I thought he was just the head of the
games. No, Fudge is still the Minister at the point.
Yeah, yeah, Barty Crouch is just the head of, like, games and whatnot.
No, I'm confused, sorry.
Oh, right, I guess this is as good a time as me to mention that other guy. Dwibs, what's the name of the guy who announced the Quidditch World Cup game?
Cornelius Fudge.
That was
the current Minister of Magic.
The current Minister.
Wait, that was Fudge announcing that?
Yeah.
Huh, okay, well... See, the subplot involving the leprechaun gold has to do with Fudge apparently having a bet with Fred and George Weasley. Basically, they made a bet that the Irish will win, but Crum from the Bulgarian team will be the one who gets the snitch. They do win the bet, and he gives them money, but it's leprechaun gold that ends up disappearing.
Well, hey, they're singing the Hogwarts song, but...
Uh-oh. Just as everything was going all nice and peachy... Is he dead, or...?
Yeah, he's dead.
Oh. It was kind of...
And we're gonna hear almost nothing about this from here on out.
It was unclear enough in the book, but the movie does it even worse, because, oh, he's dead, bye.
Wasn't there also another deleted scene surrounding that?
I think there was. Really, Fudge? Really? One of your employees...
Wait, hang on, wait. A true leader does what is right, no matter what others think. But
but
how many other world figures have done what they think is right, no matter what others thought?
Anyway, basically, the subplot in the book is that Fred and George do win a bet against Cornelius Fudge, but Fudge, being a sore loser, gives them leprechaun gold, which disappears.
After a while, yeah.
They get their comeuppance on him. I don't remember the details, though.
That's... I'm not a fan of licorice at all.
Me neither. Honestly, that's one of the few subplots I'm okay with them skipping over, if only because it made Fudge even more of a git than he already is. Also, I can't believe Fudge is not going to cancel the tournament, even though there actually now has been a death connected to it.
I mean, so much weird things have happened up until this point. Ew.
I have no idea what those are.
Are they like leeches?
Licorice snaps.
Oh.
How do you eat these? Seriously.
More like they try to eat you.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Okay. Get ready for things to be trippy, folks.
Mr. Pensieve.
Well, I mean, it's just simple. Why not take a look? What's the worst that could happen? At least it's not a diary that can somehow suck you into it.
Instead, it actually reminds me kind of like the Well of Souls from the Scooby-Doo movie.
Yeah. It's almost like I could step into it. Oh, crap!
He kind of fell into it.
And it's quite a convenient memory, too.
Also, yeah, scenes like this where the actors have to pretend Daniel Radcliffe isn't there.
Yeah. Awkward. So, it's time to stand wizard trial for... the headmaster from Durmstrang himself.
Igor.
And yes, he's from Azkaban. Needless to say, Igor is desperate to be let out of Azkaban because Azkaban be Azkaban. You'd have to be flipping mad to survive there. Yeah. Well, dead or apprehended?
He's dead.
Huh?
Well, he said the paper said he was dead.
Oh, Rookwood.
And Rita was also.
Bye.
Good day, sir.
Nope.
Oh, Snape? Oh. So Snape used to be a Death Eater, but he turned on Voldemort.
Why don't you have a proper mullet?
Yeah.
Oop.
Oh.
Longbottom.
Neville's parrot.
Barty did it?
You? Oops.
Oh.
The son.
Nope.
The doctor did it.
Why do they always try to run? And look, Mad-Eye Moody was the one who caught him.
Also, more great expressions from Daniel Radcliffe.
And David Tennant, of course.
What are you, David a snake Tenet. Now?
And he gets disowned.
Well,
normally he clicks with the tongue for no reason.
Wow, David
you
Tennant.
You are no son of mine.
David Tennant is just a treasure, isn't he?
Yeah.
Okay, now here's a little thing they kind of left the details out of. Yeah, Neville's parents, they weren't just killed by Barty Crouch. They were also killed by, let's see.
Well,
actually, they weren't killed.
They were severely tortured to the point of being vegetables.
Yeah.
They're spending their life in basically a hospital.
They're pretty much dead, though, but yeah. Well, oh, That's another thing, actually. The movies skirt around that. See, in the books, yes, it's established that they're vegetables. However, in the movies, they're pretty much considered that they were tortured to death, so...
No. In the next film...
It's Order of Phoenix, but he's established, yeah, so we'll save it for that.
In the next film, they say they suffered a fate worse than death.
Huh. I could have sworn they said they died. Maybe I misremembered that. All of a sudden, though... But yeah, by the Crucial Discourse... Weird thing, though, is that in later ones, they go into establish that it wasn't just Barty Crouch who did it. There were two others involved.
There was
reused
a dull,
footage again.
There was a huge brown bear kept moon every and the pals was mind.
No, Dumbledore. You should actually.
That's a terrible way to tell.
Just don't think about it.
Yes, yeah. Don't think about the things that you have no control
that's
over.
That's called memory extrapolation.
Okay, Dumbledore. In hindsight, there are so many better bouts of advice you could have given Harry for this movie.
That was like among the worst of advice that you could have given him.
Hello.
Awkward.
We're just showing each other our tattoos. It's fine.
Hi.
That's what a man do.
Uh-oh.
Hi.
Yeah, Snape isn't in this film much, which is a shame.
Thanks.
Uh-oh.
Oh, crap.
Yep.
I cannot stress that anymore that everyone says that Al, you know, it's funny, everyone says Alan Rickman was like the nicest guy offset off camera. Man, oh man.
That's what makes him a great actor.
Yeah. It's like how J.K. Simmons was as friendly as he was during the filming of...
It's kind of similar to the American Pie movies, whereas Sean William Scott plays the character who's supposed to be the asshole. However... The actors themselves will say that Sean William Scott is anything but. He's the nicest guy that in the cast in general.
And anyway, especially J.K. Simmons during Whiplash.
I was going to say Spider-Man.
Whiplash, he's even more of a dick. At least in Spider-Man, J. Jonah Jameson is occasionally a good guy. In Whiplash, J.K. Simmons' character is pretty much the villain.
So, for trial time...
Please, Dumbledore, kill me now.
And everyone's there with their parents, what? It seems?
Yep.
Except Harry.
Well. Okay, Filcher. Don't fuck with the canon now.
Congratulations, you get to star in this new movie.
Oh yeah, that's right, the subplot about the buttons about Harry, yeah, kinda just dropped. Which kinda makes Malfoy's participation in the story all the more weaker. So yeah, basically it's a simple bout. You go through a maze that is totally not filled with the worst
of... The first to get the cop wing. Easy.
God.
If I recall correctly, in the book, Harry at some point confronts one of those creatures that assume
a manticore.
Basically, he okay. There are at least
one. No, you know the one that in the previous movie when you need to defeat them with a ridiculous spell.
Yeah, Boggart.
Boggart.
Yeah.
He also faces off against a blast-ended skewit, a creature that was brought up during Hagrid's lessons in Book 4, which, sadly again, got cut.
He actually faced a lot of creatures in the maze.
Oh, here we go. One?
Come on.
Oh, well. That is another thing, sadly. The creatures will get cut from the maze. Again, we spent so much time on... Oh my god, I just realized we never properly resolved Ron and Hermione not fighting with each other anymore.
Yeah, so cut the I don't like it in the...
Yeah, I agree. That should have been, you know, placed better. I mean, at the end of the day, I still enjoy this movie.
Me too,
and suddenly, you can't hear the chanting, even though you're just over
and
the
it's
other side.
Way darker than it should.
Them bushes must be amazing at sound...
What?
Puns.
If you look to your right, you'll see Jack Nicholson mugging for the camera.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Triwizard Maze.
Joba, come on, we're not watching The Shining yet.
Yep.
But it's the perfect time for a Shining Joe.
Who conjured this maze?
It's like Dumbledore said.
Less cold than in The Shining.
It's like Dumbledore said, guys. People change within the maze. So apparently it's
or
a maze.
Or is this just in the grounds? I don't know.
I have to wonder, do these challenges stay the same each tournament? Like, they know exactly what they're putting students through?
Hey, Pedro.
Yes.
Funny you mentioned The Shining, considering that was also published by Warner Brothers.
Well, yeah.
Remember,
Kubrick was the only filmmaker that ever got a major film company to pull a movie out of theaters just because he wanted.
That's what movie was that?
The Clockwork Orange, remember, because of the shit that was going on in the UK. I want to pull the movie out from theaters. From the UK theaters, can you help me? And Warner Brothers just did it just so they wouldn't piss him off because they didn't want to risk him going to another film company. That's how powerful he was at the time, to give you an idea.
Hey, Crumb.
Wow, Crumb's eyes look more dead than... Well, these bushes.
You know, lady, you kind of suck at this.
Yeah.
Watch Evil Dead, anyone?
Oh my god, a Bulgarian, so scary. And,
again, watch Evil Dead, anyone? Like, I'm pretty sure this was intentional.
I'm still waiting for Evil Dead 4, by the way, Sam.
Sorry, Pedro. Bruce Campbell has slept too long.
Wait. Evil Dead 4 is still on the way?
No. It's a common joke, Jova, that fans of Evil Dead are still waiting for Sam Raimi to finally give us that movie.
Let me guess.
There was a TV series, but got cancelled after, like, season 2, I think.
Which is a shame, because I hear that Netflix series was actually pretty good. But,
I mean,
okay.
Bruce Campbell definitely enjoyed being in it.
So, just...
Anyway, this maze is actually... Oh, bye.
So does...
Also, something seems wrong with Crumb.
Yep.
And Fleur, well, she's a little seated. Hopefully they'll be able to save her from that.
Although, they said they'll be guarding the perimeter, so they should be able to see the red sparks.
No, what I mean is, like, well, hopefully they'll be able to find her wherever she is buried into the bushes.
Yeah, maybe the bushes just decided to let them go.
Fortunately, we due to this storm, things are about to get even weirder.
So, did Evil Dead 3, like, end on a cliffhanger or something?
Kinda. Well, no, the original cut, Jova, basically ends in a straightforward manner. Ash returns to his timeline and everything. There's an alternate ending, though, that is more of a cliffhanger. It implies a potential dystopic future because, as he quotes, he's left too long.
So yeah.
I thought Expelliarmus only got rid of one. Send you.
Well,
they keep changing.
Yeah, isn't Stupefy the spell that's used for stunning people?
Yeah.
Also, so yeah, he's bewitched.
Quick, let's race. Last man to get there has to start in twilight.
Oh God! Wait, what the
well,
heck
that's
is?
The thing.
Wait, what the bloody hell is twilight?
Let's just say I'm clairvoyant. Okay, trust me, it's not a good thing.
Whichever one of us gets out alive by the end, they don't have to be. They don't
so,
have to be in twilight.
Yeah,
yes?
It's looking like Harry has a clear win now.
Okay, I got it. The winner gets to be in a Now You See Me sequel. Wait, what the hell's Now You See Me?
What's with this camera angle? That camera angle looks like Harry was contemplating leaving him behind seriously.
I think
he was contemplating being evil.
I love
How
that
spell. How about he send you instead? We're plans.
Yeah, but that will set Cedric on fire.
Well,
All right. We wouldn't want that now, would we?
Dale? Is it? Calm down.
I mean, he would just sparkle anyway, so.
Dio, he's not dead yet.
The glitter, serious.
He's not dead yet. Yeah, well, like Dumbledore said.
I was totally gonna let you die.
It's like Dumbledore said, this maze changes people.
Uh-oh.
Run! Jeez. On second thought, Overlook Hotel, eat your heart out.
Again, hopefully the climate is less cold here.
We'll both take it for a tie!
Free!
And there you go. Both take it, so...
Turns out that it was a porthole. What's a porthole? Well, if you recall at the very start of the...
With the shoe.
Basically, a portkey is an item of any sort that will transport you. And look at that! The house
They're in Little Hangleton.
And wouldn't you know, also, the house was of the Riddle family. Now, where have we heard the name Riddle before? Grab it again. Just grab it again. Yeah. We can get out of here.
Yes, I've been
here. Actually, I don't think it. I think it's one-way use.
No, I've been here.
In my dreams, bats surround me and carry me into the air somehow.
Yeah.
Also, Tom Riddle died in the middle of World War II, apparently.
Sure he did. Also, Tio, the port key does work both ways. Like, Perry's literally saying, get back to the cup.
Oh, yeah, okay. Big question, Jova, because I don't remember this. Because, I mean, oh, that's nice.
And Cedric is dead.
How did Peter manage to get that baby form of Voldemort?
Basically, Voldemort wasn't properly killed because, I'll just say this right now, Horcruxes.
But that's the thing. As I mentioned in Book 6 and 7, he technically never had a chance to properly use one. Ew.
Apparently, when the Avada Kedavra curse reflected onto him, it didn't kill him, but it just pretty much destroyed his being.
There you go. The ingredients revive a person. The bone of a father. Take him without the consensus.
I don't want to give you my bone. Let me give you a hand, sir.
You just need the flesh. You don't need to cut your own hand.
I can't tell if this is him.
Hey, what if he cut off the hand where his finger was missing?
Also, he's taking that pain in his arm very okay-ish. And there you go. Blood with the enemy.
Maybe you should have saved, you know, the cutting off your hand thing for the last bit.
I guess that's how the ritual works. You need to do in order. I mean, remember, Jovai, that's what happens in Key's Quest 3. You need to do things in order.
I guess.
Who wrote this shit?
J.K. Rowling and Steve Clovis.
So yeah, anyway, Tio, to basically cover the basics, Voldemort should have been killed, but because of Horcruxes, he couldn't be killed, so it just destroyed his body and reduced him to a lesser man. Of course, he wanted specifically the blood of Harry for a certain reason. Don't worry, though, I think his clothes came back. Yes, they did.
And ladies and gentlemen, our Voldemort, played by Ralph Fiennes.
Why doesn't he have a nose?
No nose face.
This was admittedly a big moment for fans to wait to see what Voldemort would look like on screen, so yeah.
Mm-hmm. You need a skincare routine.
Wow, who knew Voldemort? Frick. Also, yeah, Cedric.
It's alive?
Yes, the wand.
That shot there of Cedric looks so mocking, like, oh, look how close he was to the cup. Yeah. And now he's dead.
Never to be revived again. But don't worry, he'll be revived in a new life of sparkles and deers.
Oh. You're not getting your hand back.
Oh no, he'll get him something
basically
better.
Yeah, reviving
first, the dark mark.
The mark, yeah.
Basically that's the signal saying I'm back, everyone.
Time to rise and shine for the wakes of evil. And it turns out that Death Eaters were the ones who attacked the fair at the beginning of this movie.
Yep. Yeah.
Well, they said that at the beginning of the movie.
Yeah.
Or Ron's dad did.
Oh.
Disappointed.
Oh, crab.
Oh, the father of Goyle.
Yep.
The professor and
I
Marianne.
Wonder who that could be.
What do you know? They're all the parents of Slytherins.
Wait. You're telling me that Lucius is evil?
I'm sorry, my lord. I was in the United States voicing another villain.
What excuses.
But I swear it's awesome. He's even more powerful than you are.
Surely you just...
American, though. I don't know why.
Yeah. Keep in mind, again, all of this happened because... Ron did not suspect it about his pet rat.
If he had gotten rid of that rat, or if Sirius had gotten to kill him, we wouldn't be here.
Wow. I would cut, test that. Voldemort, please.
How did you forget Harry was?
Boy, Grindelwald would be pissed.
Well, that's the thing, Jova. The more time, the more the books pass, the more Voldemort turns out to be a shady villain, so maybe Grindelwald actually has a chance.
Wouldn't that be interesting if Grindelwald comes back? Well, I mean,
Maybe that's what the approach that we're getting, like foreshadowing for future series.
Turns out Harry's actually not as invincible. His mother just placed a protection charm over him.
Which, according to Dumbledore, was just love.
But apparently, the only way that Voldemort could now touch him was if he shared the blood of him.
Boop.
This is awkward.
Ralph finds his face.
that happened.
However, Voldemort seems to be very sportive, so he's like, okay, let's settle this 1v1b, bitch.
He's also very theatrical.
You're just jealous because Dumbledore trusted him better than you did, Prefect Boy.
Oh, constipation.
God, he's quite a thespian for torture. Let's see. So he's used Imperius on him, and he's used Crucio on him. What's next? Oh, right. The big one.
Expelliarmus.
Bet you did not say that.
Yeah. Well, he tried, but... Well... So why not kill me now, then?
Because I'm going to do it in the most thespian, magical manner possible.
He's going to enjoy this.
Sadly, you're so wrong on these words, Voldemort, sadly. After this night, everyone on the internet will question your powers.
Oh god, you're comparing yourself to God.
Admiral Zhao, should we do something? Oh wait, sorry, we're not at the right studio, Eve.
Also, Jason Isaacs is Admiral Zhao. All right.
Yeah, that's what I meant.
Now come on, Potter. I want your death to go exactly the way I want it, to every letter of the law.
Yeah. Come on, Lucius, use your firebending power. Yeah.
Hold on, Voldemort wants him to himself. And Expelliarmus is just
now we're going, yeah, full DBZ on this shit.
At least it doesn't take 30 episodes.
You know, this is your reminder, folks. You're looking at two guys holding sticks at each other, and it somehow looks epic.
But sir, it looks like you're struggling.
Well, so this is better than in Yu-Gi-Oh! Where they fight with ancient Egyptian laser beams.
Yes.
Sir, are you sure we shouldn't help you?
No, I got it! Maybe not!
That's better.
Okay, this is where things get weird.
Yeah, it unleashes a bunch of ghosts, including that random janitor guy who died.
Hi, I'm just here.
Believe in yourself, Harry.
Yeah, basically, the ghosts...
That looks like a homing shot, Harry. Be careful.
Basically, the ghosts of either side go and root the others on against. Please, whatever you do, Harry, don't let them revive me as a vampire. Wait, what do you mean by don't? I've seen things from this clairvoyant from Portugal. Whoosh! Oops. Ghost power!
There we are.
No. I prepared for this for years!
No. Ding.
No.
Yay! Yeah. Also, Cedric's dead!
Yeah, how do they not know that? I mean, she does. Well, sort of you do. He did it! He's dead! Oh, wait. He's dead?
Oh, shit. What?
Somebody died?
You're telling me that someone died in these events? Gee.
Again.
Who could have possibly?
Hey, Cornelius Fudge, don't you feel so proud of not canceling these games? Oh, don't
worry. I'm starting to realize what the Dursleys don't like the wizards.
A boy, Fudge. How nice. Oh, that's nice, Fudge. Trying to move the body to not grab attention.
Don't worry, he'll be resurrected soon.
Do you want to break his heart even more?
He'll be alive.
He'll be a sparkling vampire. That's a fate worse than death. Actually, no. That's not the worst thing. Him being a date with Kristen Stewart. Yeah.
Should we put down our trumpets, sir?
That's you playing the sad music, isn't it?
Yeah.
You insensitive asshole.
Oh, shut up!
So, yeah. Sadly, wow, Harry has escaped Voldemort. Diggory is no more.
Oh, well.
But at least Moody was considerate enough to drag him away.
And lock the door.
and lock the door.
Okay, that might be a bit much.
And close the curtains, but wait,
that's not really necessary, sir.
You shut the door, mate. Why would you close the
This is a grieving room. We are here to grieve.
I guess.
Wait, how do you know about the...
Ow. What? Aren't you gonna tend to this?
Mm-hmm.
It was all a bit much, really.
Oh, crap. Where's my alcohol?
Oops, I'm out.
Empty.
We're out of tea.
Jeez, is this what happens when a Brit doesn't have their tea?
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh.
There's a reason I need it.
I see. Suddenly
Wait. Him asking about the Dark Lord doesn't raise any flags, but mentioning a grave, mentioning the location does.
I guess it's because in the heat of the moment... You know, that kind
also,
of
stands out. Harry kind of screamed about Voldemort being back, you know, in front of everyone, he didn't mention the graveyard at all.
Uh-oh.
He's mocking Hagrid, the prick.
Moody? Wow, if I didn't know better, I think you were suggesting that the Triwizard Tournament was even more of a farce than it already looked like.
Calm down.
Is this multiple takes again?
I wonder. Well, here it works because Mad-Eye Moody is mad.
Also, that's one thing I need to question about the goblet. It's like, it recognizes anti-aging magic, but it can't recognize when somebody puts someone else's name in there?
It's strictly just the age, Leroy.
Evil.
Which,
yeah,
when you think about
Dumbledore,
it...
the great genius.
It's the blood of Voldemort now.
So Mad-Eye Moody may have actually been in leagues with Voldemort, which is kind of shocking, considering how Mad-Eye Moody is...
Sure.
Wait, what?
I'm not sure Voldemort would reward you for...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he wants to do it himself.
There you go. Tom Veritas Serum.
Yep.
Oh... Okay, so remember how we saw that chest shaking a lot? Yeah, someone was really putting up a fight in there.
Nice
That's
effect.
An interesting chest.
Nice effect, though.
Hmm.
Who the heck was in there? Peter Dinklage? Maybe not.
Nope.
The real Mad-Eye Moody. Yep, it was Polyjuice Potion he was drinking all the time, and it was
Apologize
him.
To Harry.
Apologize to Harry.
Oh, come on, Severus.
No. No, you will either be silent or I will be forced to...
He's regenerating.
Oh, no.
Throw you into the Nakatomi Plaza.
Wait, Brandon Gleeson, he's becoming... He's... He is...
Good.
He is...
Oh, gosh, that eye needs to stop moving.
It was a CGI effect. No, it's just a doctor.
Oh my god, it's Kilgrave from Jessica Jones! Wow, he regenerated. You're right, Shirai. Ow, that hurts! But yeah.
Could everyone stop pulling the arm that somebody shanked me? You know?
And we never hear from Barty Crouch Jr. ever again.
Yeah, he's probably going to rot in Azkaban.
Which is weird considering the prison break that happens in the next book. Remember how I mentioned that Barty Crouch Jr. was not the only person who tortured Neville's parents? Yeah, remember that for next time.
I thought he was going to stab him in the eye.
Here's the thing. There also is another thing that got cut to the fact that Barty Crouch ends up being reduced to a vegetable because when the Ministry of Magic arrives, they use a Dementor on him.
Oh, they did?
Yeah, I remember specifically at the end of the book, basically, when the Ministry of Magic arrives, they use a Dementor and they destroy him before he can get any useful information.
Oh my god, I just remembered there was a subplot involving his house elf, Winky! They completely cut Winky. Oh my god, Dobby's supposed to appear in this movie too! Because it's here that they establish that there's the house elves working in there, and oh my god. Now I'm remembering why I'm a bit iffy with the cuts made here. Again, there was so much stuff we could have... You know what? I'll save that for my final thoughts.
No, he wasn't. He was killed by Wormtail.
Details.
So now that's you're breaking the rules, Dumbledore.
The reason why Barty Crouch was killed...
Not telling him was an insult to his memory. How about incorrectly telling him how he died, you asshole?
Supposedly, the reason why the Ministry used the mentor of Barty Crouch Jr. was to cover up the story, basically, as will become very clear at the beginning of the next movie. The Ministry doesn't want to keep this information out of hand.
Basically, what happened was that, essentially, Barty Crouch Sr. did not want his son to go down, so what did he do? Barty Crouch Jr.'s mother took the Polyjuice Potion and disguised herself as him, and he snuck out as his mother. Yeah, plenty of messed up jokes regarding that. And of course, one of the few people to know was his house elf, Winky, who, let's just say, Barty Crouch treated like crap, and eventually fired her, and she went to move in with Dobby at Hogwarts because house elves have fair-paying jobs there. So, oh my god, there was a subplot about Hermione with the house elves too! God.
That was in the fifth book, I think, actually.
Not for nothing, Jova.
Never mind.
Not for nothing, Jova, but half those plot points you described could end up really, really kind of... I mean, again, the movies are pretty long as is.
But that's the thing, though, Dwibs. Maybe if you know the movie didn't dedicate its time to some of the more pointless stuff that we've complained about. Like, again... You'd think they would have focused some stuff on Dobby returning, considering how that helps Dobby's character development for the finale.
Wow, Dumbledore's actually apologizing.
I put you in danger
this year. Yeah, that's rare.
But the first, second, and third time to put you in danger, I'm not sorry, but for this one, where you had to face a clumsy dragon swimming around in some pond where you weren't really in danger, and facing a bunch of scary twigs and bushes, I'm so sorry.
Hey, how about you apologize for book 6?
But that hasn't happened yet.
Oh, I want you to apologize beforehand. Trust me, you may not get the chance.
Yep.
Yeah, by the way, I totally didn't steal that little bit I just said from
Jules. Okay, I think I'm starting to recall why a lot of fans aren't too happy with what got cut and what got kept for this movie. I mean, you know, the most important stuff is kept, but it is a shame that they cut a lot of details that would have helped, you know, properly build up for stuff that happens in later movies. Okay.
What if,
Yeah?
Well, what if, like, if... Well, that's one thing, Jova. If Lord of the Rings, despite a successful film trilogy, can get an Amazon show with a huge budget, I wouldn't be surprised if Harry Potter gets one down the line at some point.
Yeah. Harry Potter getting a Netflix show.
Or Amazon Prime.
Again, the potential in world building and lore is there, so might as well use it.
Also, there may or may not be a thing between them.
Flip, but don't worry, Ron. Don't worry, Ron. I will get married to another not you.
I think she gets
married. I'll marry into the Weasley family, absolutely.
Oh god. Oh, but what about let's see.
Which brother did she marry again? Percy, was it?
Bill.
Bill.
Oh, right, Bill.
Okay.
But hey, you know, at least we
Hooray!
Can...
Hooray! Yay, you did nothing!
Hooray!
Who are you again?
I don't know, I'm pretty sure they still got paid reasonably well for being in this movie, though.
I think Crumb basically got the worst out of this. He's basically...
tarnished. I think Fleur did, though. I mean, Fleur's done nothing.
But keep in mind...
Crumb was supposed to be a more important factor, though.
Crumb is not just that. Crumb is supposed also to be a Quidditch champion and everything, so imagine the fact that he couldn't manage to win this.
Yeah. Also, well, Ron and Hermione are friends again, guys.
Yes. Considering two people died, whether indirectly or directly as a result of this year's tournament, I don't think they'll mind Crumb all that much.
Yeah, Crumb doesn't mind it.
You think the death count now is bad?
So,
wow.
Yeah, this ending is a bit, this is basically a bit bittersweet. Dark things are awaited, but it's not all completely bleak for the moment.
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't worry, Cedric Diggory died, but here's a nice uplifting happy ending. Oh my god, you know what I'm gonna miss?
What? The color?
The music quality.
Oh.
Does it really get worse? I don't remember it.
The fifth film was alright, the sixth film was...
The thing I'm going to miss...
This film could be entirely skipped over, honestly.
The thing I'm going to miss most is the color. Oh, by the way, for something called Goblet of Fire, the Goblet of Fire kind of just comes and goes.
That's the thing, Jova. When it comes to objects of which stories are named of, I've seen worse in terms of representation. Like, things that just appear for a second and then get dropped immediately. That are supposed to be called in the title. Anyway, no credit after credit scene, so final thoughts. Who wants to start?
Can I go first?
Sure.
I don't hate this movie. I mean, there's a lot of things I like. Solid. I mean, even if Michael Gambon was given really odd direction. I think I really love the music. And, at least the basic plot was told well enough. But again, as like I said before, one thing Mike Newell, the director, really struggles with is pacing. Stuff goes by rather quickly in this film. And again, with Prince of Persia show you he learned nothing. The film was really mixed. The film was really bad priorities as to what to keep and what not to keep. They keep the Yule Ball, which was pointless. But,
Oh, hey, Gary Oldman.
Yeah, you're in the film for a minute.
He gets billing over Miranda Richardson.
Yeah, but Gary Oldman was in a big budget film this year as well. He was in Batman Begins, so...
Yeah.
I don't mind.
Go on.
But, the biggest issues with the film were the pacing... Stuff that they probably shouldn't have kept, they did keep him for some reason, and a few characters kind of got the shaft a bit. I think Snape got the worst of it. He's barely in this movie.
He does still get some of the funniest scenes, though. Still,
yeah.
All right. Well, that's me done. It's a fun but flawed movie.
Also, bye, Robert Pattinson. No longer will you be typecast for Harry Potter. May your journeys lead you to new, greater, bolder films that will have you shine brightly.
I feel bad for him.
Who's next?
I'll go next. Yeah, I still really like the film. However, I'll start with the negatives. As you know, my biggest issue with this is its adaptation choices. Like, again... The stuff that gets cut is weird. Like, it's... Okay, the Dursley scene, I could get that being cut. Even though it was funny, it wasn't necessary. However, cutting out context and stuff like the Riddle House family... Again, that's fair, but then they repeat that sequence over and over more than they need to. No, the point where cuts start getting really off the walls is when first they cut off the finale of the Quidditch World Cup. It's like... Well, gee, you built this up like that, and you think, oh, well, they're gonna do more with Crumb otherwise. No! Like, poor Crumb. Again, he's a guy who's supposed to be a recurring character in later books as well, but sadly doesn't get the development I would have expected of him. And then the other stuff that gets cut, like Winky, the house elf, who I don't think ever makes it into the movie series. Then again, same thing happens to Peeves, the poor guy. Well, maybe that's his punishment and whatnot. But anyway, I digress. And yeah, stuff like Barty Crouch Sr. getting killed. Eh, fast over. Or, again, what actually happens to Barty Crouch Jr.? You know, his comeuppance in the book is, remind me, Tio, he actually does get the Dementor's Kiss that was meant for him, right? Tio?
He's burped.
Oh, Shiroi, okay. He gets the Dementor's Kiss.
Actually, oh, there he is.
Go ahead.
Tio, remind me, Barty Crouch Jr. does get the Dementor's Kiss in the end, right?
Yes,
right. Again, you know, stuff that we could have seen, but got cut for stuff that people didn't even really like from the book. Like, Ron and Harry's falling out, that kind of amounted to nothing. The Yule Ball, which was just a social event of sorts, which kind of goes nowhere. They cut out Hagrid's romance with the headmistress.
Well, as I said, the ball specifically is just a part of the tradition of the tournament, so...
Well, true, I get that. It's just how much time is wasted on that. Especially building up ships that... Well, are gonna get torpedoed, to say the least. But then again, that was sort of an issue with the book as well, so... Not as bad as that. Again, it's just my main issue is like, well, there's so much stuff they could have adapted that would have been better for this than what they left in, and what they cut out is weird. That said, though, there are some scenes they did improve. Again, special mention goes to the dragon scene. And hey, you know, them not trying to make it seem like the students were never in danger during the water challenge... Kind of more dark, but at least it's not them trying to BS their way out of it. Kind of love how they emphasize Fudge's really ill-willed temperament of trying to keep the things just to try and prove that he's right. That'll eventually come back in book 5. So there are some nice details added. And overall, this is still a movie that is one of my more liked Harry Potter movies. The costume design is good as usual. The music here is phenomenal, to say the least. Like, I mean, I definitely do love the soundtrack for this movie. It's one of the few that I actually do like to go back and just listen to. The story, in and of itself, is kind of a weird hodgepodge of sports, school hijinks, and death-defying... Again, kind of a...
It's like an anime.
Go figure. Thankful... Oh my god, there's even the tsundere's.
Oh my god.
Oh god, Harry Potter the anime. I can only imagine. So yeah, but still though, despite its issues, it's still an overall fun film. The music is great, the characters are good for the most part when they come out of the stupid arcs. And the writing is definitely on par. The actors pretty much all deliver their lines to the best of their ability. And David Tennant's a flipping riot as a guest star.
So he was having fun, clearly.
So yes. It's another good Harry Potter movie. Far from the best, but also far from the worst. Who's next?
Do you mind if I go next?
Sure.
Alright. I really enjoy this movie. I still have a soft spot, like I said, for the Chris Columbus era. But compared to the shift that Prisoner of Azkaban was, I'm really more appreciating this one, even with the cuts. The only ones I may do mind are Barty Crouch's demise, and on a more personal point of view, the Dursleys at the beginning. But like Jova said, that one has no real bearings on the plot, so... I could see the thought process behind cutting that away. But like I said, the cuts are not my big issue with it. I don't even have anyone in particular. I just really enjoy this movie, even though maybe the color, like the saturation, the next couple of movies will definitely become bleaker and bleaker as time passes, but you can start seeing the effect here. But I don't think it hinders the movie. I enjoy practically all of it. The score is actually really good. And like Jova mentioned, it doesn't use even that much of the traditional Harry Potter theme like the previous movies did. Instead, try to do something unique with it.
So even the trials were all great to me, like the sense of danger that these things provided. But and the characters involved, yeah, maybe Fleur, I keep forgetting her name, the Bobaton student, didn't do that much, and probably she was more of a goof up. But I don't think that was a problem. I guess the really most notable thing that could have been reworked or discarded in favor of other stuff would have been the fallout between Ron and Harry. Like, that goes nowhere anyway, so you might as well gloss over or do something else. But it's like something that's like 5 minutes, so at the worst I can say, like, I press the fast forward button for that, for a case like this, I guess. But again, overall, really enjoyed this movie. Not my favorite Harry Potter movie, but still very up on the list. Next.
All right.
Pedro, you want to go
ahead?
Oh, me? Okay.
Yep.
Well, pretty much almost everybody else said. I mean, I mean, granted, like I said, I have no context for what the book did. Okay, I only know from what you guys have told me. But it does seem like, from what you guys said, that, yeah, they could have made much better decisions with what to keep out of the movie and what to actually bring in from the book. Outside of that, though, I still think the movie is really fun, and the characters are still, for the most part, just as good as they are, mm-hmm. as they're supposed to be. So it still works fine for me and does a great job with that climax in particular. Is my favorite part.
Yeah. Again, like, they managed to make people holding sticks look epic.
Well, you can do anything can be done if the filmmakers know what they're doing. But anyway.
Yeah.
But yeah, like it's the climax is where you, I kind of consider it kind of a transition. Yes, it is true that Prisoner of Azkaban was significantly darker compared to the first two movies, but this, I feel like this is where the franchise starts definitely graduating. This is basically the equivalent of the Yokawa Shadowside movie. This is where the franchise officially starts growing up with its audience, basically. Mm-hmm.
That might be part of why I like this movie a bit better than Prisoner of Azkaban, and only that it feels like it's a more natural transition with how weirdly different things are.
I like Prisoner of Azkaban, if anything, because of the Back to the Future-esque climax that it does have. But I still also enjoy the climax of this one better. Like, I feel like Ron was just kind of put in the back burner for the climax of Prisoner of Azkaban.
Yeah.
You know?
True.
So, so that's basically it. Granted, he was injured, so at least they gave him a good reason, but it was still kind of a bummer. Outside of that, yeah, it's really good. I still think, even though the score, even though Patrick Doyle's score is good, I still kind of miss John Williams, to be honest. I mean, this was still back when John Williams still had juice left in him, you know, because, like, Well, that's the thing, though, is I don't even care much for his new Star Wars scores.
No, but what I was going to say was part of the reason why he didn't come back for this was because 2005 was quite a busy year for him. Yeah. He had War of the Worlds. He had Revenge of the Sith, which was his best one out of that year. He had Memoirs of a Geisha. He had a Spielberg film, another Spielberg film, I think, as well.
I'm guessing a project like this would have been quite demanding on top of everything else.
Well, yeah. That's
this. No dragons were harmed in the making of this movie.
Yeah. the sad part here is that John Williams will always prioritize the Spielberg project over any others because of his friendship with him, which is a shame because he would be much more useful here than in fucking War of the Worlds. But
yeah,
that's a different story altogether. Regardless, no, I'm not. But anyway, the point is, it's a really good movie. So far, of the first four movies, my favorite is still Chamber of Secrets.
Oh, yeah.
Not my overall favorite Harry Potter movie. My favorite is just basically a combination of the two parts of Deathly Hallows.
So basically, Deathly Hallows.
Yeah.
Basically. In its entirety.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, because I like to think of those two movies as one, because it really feels like the first movie, I see it as the character development as part, and part two as the big payoff of the character development.
I see it as one film because it's based off of one book, so yeah.
Well, true. Regardless, it's a really solid one, I think. Go ahead. I'm done.
All right, Shiro.
All right, I really do enjoy this movie. It does have a lot of flaws, but they're... You know, there are lots of little flaws. There's nothing major that actually takes away from the enjoyment of the overall thing. In terms of what I wish they would have kept, I think it was because I don't remember a lot of the books, unfortunately. So I'm going to take Jova's word for it that there was more build up to the whole Harry and Ron debacle. I'm going to take your word for that. Mm-hmm. So it would have been nice if we actually saw more of that, or, you know, Ron not being an asshole from day one, mm-hmm. and a little more around Barty's death. Aside from that, they didn't need to go too much into the whole relationship thing, especially since that's kind of the entire point of Half-Blood Prince as a movie.
Oh boy, Half-Blood Prince.
Yeah, we'll get to that when we get to it. But I love the music in this movie. Mm-hmm. The pacing is relatively okay. The major issue I have is we just suddenly jumped to the third trial. Like that bit was just, they kicked the movie into high gear essentially at that point.
Yeah,
like a scene really... that was meant to be there, got cut. It's like there was a scene originally in it, but it was just like, is this important? The film's coming out in 5 minutes. No.
Someone accidentally deleted it.
Wouldn't that be something?
But I like the humor in this movie as well, particularly the ferret scene. The classes with Mad-Eye Moody. Like, Mad-Eye Moody is great for this movie, actually. Or who we thought was Mad-Eye. Yes.
Like, I think the ferret scene is the last time we ever see Draco Malfoy.
In this movie. Yeah. I think so. Well, there is that scene with the tiger and Goyle not cheering up anymore after the second trial, I think.
Well, actually, I'm pretty sure they were cheering in the crowd before the start of the third trial. At least I think they were.
I think. True. God, poor Draco for this movie.
Yeah, his father gets more screen time, and he's not even in the movie for half of it.
Don't worry, though. He'll have more of a role to play in 5 and 6.
And yeah, that's pretty much it. Aside from, you were talking about the graveyard scene. That one moment was really weird.
Yeah.
When Voldemort's touching his scar. That was just, what the fuck were you doing?
What is it with bald, pasty guys getting what looks to be orgasms when they torture
them? He looks like he's getting off on this. Seriously.
On the subject of Voldemort, I do love how, like, the very next thing that's on screen after that Frank guy got killed was pretty much the film saying, oh, tea's ready.
Yeah, basically. And, I think it was you who mentioned it earlier, Dwibs. I think with this whole trend that's come about now, I think this series would do quite well as a TV adaptation or a Netflix adaptation.
Yeah, if Lord of the Rings could get one, why can't this?
Maybe eventually.
And, I mean, J.K. Rowling is always saying how she's done with Harry Potter, but we know she never is, because it's the only way she makes her money most of the time.
It's typical, Shiroi. Kojima was done with Metal Gear for over 15 years, and we all know how that turned out.
I swear she has a Scrooge's money pit. I'm willing to bet she has one.
I'm never doing another Studio Ghibli movie ever again.
Yeah, it's like, we don't believe you.
I got it. She has a secret money pit somewhere in a secret location in Edinburgh. Jumps in there every so often.
Right, but that's pretty much it. Overall, a pretty fun movie. Not my favorite. Going back through them again this year, because the thing about the UK is that we actually show them yearly for multiple weeks, but yeah, nice. That's actually going on right now. But so far, my favorite is still Prisoner of Azkaban, moment. So, mm-hmm. And yep, that's all I have to say.
Okay then.
So, see you for Order of the Phoenix.
What? I like Order of the Phoenix.
Where Harry goes right into puberty.
Oh.
I sadly consider that as my least
favorite. Okay, guys, think of it this way. At least in the movie, we don't have to deal with Harry being a whiny bitch.
True,
yes. I'm going to say this right now. For every trouble I have with the adaptation cuts that Goblet of Fire made, I bless Order of the Phoenix for the cuts it made.
See you for that, everyone.
See ya.
Ta-ta. See ya.